barbecue and visit with your favorite Buzz personalities. It's the 20th annual Double B's BuzzBQ, sponsored by Michelob Ultra, Gravely Mowers, Oaklawn Hot Springs, Tito's Handmade Vodka, Lion Legal, Jez Camper Rental, and LRS, benefiting Ronald McDonald House Charities of Arkansas and North Louisiana.
Hey, it's David Basil, and the annual Luxury Pool and Spa 20% off store-wide sale is going on now through this Saturday. Don't miss it. This sale includes everything store-wide, including patio furniture by Fisco, rebates on Pool Life and Bakusil pool chemicals, and even spas like the one I have at my house are discounted lower than truckload pricing. Daily giveaways include PK Grills and Luxury Pool and Spa $150 gift cards. It's a 20% off store-wide sale going on now through Saturday at Luxury Pool and Spa in Conway and Russellville. Check them out online at luxurypoolarkansas.com.
This is Pat Bradley for Whit Davis. Do you feel a draft around your windows? Does condensation constantly build up? What about high energy bills? It may be time for you to reach out to my good friends over at Whit Davis. Not only do they sell replacement windows, but they can also refer to you to a host of professionals who'll measure and install them for you. New windows can improve your home's energy efficiency while boosting your curb appeal. So what are you waiting for? Give Whit Davis a call. And remember, Whit Davis Lumber Plus is more than just a lumberyard.
Hello, Buzz listeners. It's Chris Zender, and I've got some big news. Fletcher Dodge has big discounts on all new Rams, up to $11,000 off new Ram 2500s and up to $10,000 off new half-ton Rams. But that's not all. We got 0% financing on new Ram Bighorns for 72 months. Yes, I said 0% for 72 months. Or how about $10,000 off new Jeep Gladiators? And we have the new 2024 Jeep Compass four-wheel drives for only $424 a month with zero down and no gimmicks. We're getting new inventory every week, so come in and let us know what you're looking for. We're ready to make a deal. We have pre-owned vehicles starting as low as $199 a month at zero down. Don't worry about your credit. If other dealers have told you no, come see us or apply from anywhere at FletcherCredit.com. Fast, easy, and simple approval process. And let us help you get into a new or pre-owned vehicle. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Come see us in person at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood or shop online at FletcherDeals.com.
There are no ordinary days in Arkansas. Hike to inspiring summits, bike on world-class trails, or fish in sparkling waters. Or see some of the world's top art collections and explore historic sites dedicated to everything from civil rights to rock and roll. After that, eat some award-winning barbecue and sip a local craft beer. So go on, get out there, and explore what the natural state has to offer. Find out more at Arkansas.com.
What's up, everybody? DJ Williams here with The Zone. A big Wednesday lineup for you. Joe Klein is going to be in studio thanks to Corky's and Hagen Smith. Thanks to our friends at Stiefel Financial. Talk all thing Razorback baseball. Kevin Kelly is going to be here probably talking smack to Joe Klein. He's here thanks to our friends at the Little Rock Athletic Club. Chris Alley with your Average Guy movie review thanks to Rock and Roll Sushi. And everybody got that tax return back. You need to know what to do with it. Scott Inman is going to be here with Gen Wealth. That's all starts at 10 a.m. The Zone, where sports and entertainment come crashing
together. It's Justin Acre for Serta Pro Painters, and if you're like me, this time of the year I'm spending a lot of time at the house watching basketball games and baseball games, and then I also start looking around the house and noticing some paint on the wall might have cracked, or you might see some scuffs on the wall, and you want to get that updated. If that's the case at your house, you need to get Serta Pro Painters on the case today. SertaPro.com, that's Serta with a C. All you have to do is go to their website, and they will come over, give you a free estimate, and you can trust them to get the job done right, because they take pride in what they do. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated. When it comes to choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
Stanley Wood Chevrolet Buick GMC wants to make sure you're getting the service you deserve and your vehicle needs. Choices in sales, service, fair prices, and relationships built on trust is the Wood family promise, and we stand by it. When you purchase a new vehicle from us, the first oil change and inspection is free. Come see us today and experience the Wood family promise. Stanley Wood Chevrolet Buick GMC in Batesville, just south of the airport, online at stanleywoodchevrolet.com. We are professional grade.
From the Eat My Catfish studios, it's time for Arkansas's number one caller-driven sports show. It's Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network with your hosts, Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer. Lock it in and get ready to dial us up. Drive Time Sports is on the air.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer standing by in Northwest Arkansas. I'm Randy Rainwater from the Capital City. Good afternoon, Mr. Rick Schaefer.
Oh, it is a good afternoon, Randy. Boy, what a great day to play baseball with Arkansas and Texas Tech. Right now it's 78 degrees, sunny. It's going to be a beautiful night at Bomb Walker Stadium.
It has been overcast all day long. In fact, a very, very slight sprinkle. In fact, UALR, or Little Rock, baseball is to take on UCA. That game that was scheduled for today has been pushed into tomorrow in anticipation of this rain. But I know my wife was complaining. She's got to go out and water the flowers now, the plants. I'm like, okay. Go out and do a rain dance or something. But, yeah,
well,
should be.
You want your flowers to look nice. It's okay to water them.
Well, I understand that. Yeah. But she was anticipating Mother Nature to take care of it for her.
I see.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, that's an important step. That. Oh, wow. I mean, we hadn't been on the air 10 seconds still already. We're hearing from Doubting Thomas from our live feed feedback. Randy, this is a preemptive strike against all positivity and happiness on the future of this team. Which team? He says, no way, Jose. I've been a fan of this team for over 2,000 years. Wow.
Really?
Football has no depth at linebacker. By the way, there's a couple of linebackers.
In the portal.
Yeah. One from Florida, now one from Tennessee. So
go get them.
Yeah. We'll talk to Trey about that a little bit later on. Or the offensive line. We'll go 3-7 this year. They're only going to play 10 games, Doubting Thomas. What happened to at least two other games?
Well, that's all they played 2,000 years ago.
Oh, okay. Okay.
He's gotten lost in the
gotcha.
Frame here. Yeah.
Baseball will lose 5 games this week to Texas Tech and South Carolina. Basketball only has one player on the team. What more do you need, Doubting Thomas? It only takes one player to win, doesn't it? All you got to do is, you know, think of Hoosiers. That's my team out there. You won't fool me. Oh, by the way, with Doubting Thomas, did they not teach y'all right back 2,000 years ago? Y'all won't fool me. Oh, I guess that's supposed to be by the way. With wayward, S-T-U-A-R-D-S, a positivity. I have a duty to this state and the great fans to provide realistic expectation. Also, I think Rick's jokes are pretty corny and deserve the buzzer. Okay.
Well, I don't think you have any obligation to be negative to people of the state. And I'm surprised you've learned how to text when your first writings would have been on papyrus.
Well, actually, this is the live feed.
He's been around 2,000 years. Well, you got it to you somehow, right?
Yeah. Well, the Buzz text line is where I.
You didn't get a scroll in the mail, did you?
No.
That's what I mean. He's learned.
No. He has advanced throughout the years. Okay. Let's get started with Nick. Nick, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Yeah, I was calling about that guy, Doubting Thomas.
Yeah.
Negativity.
Yeah. I think he's being funny.
I mean, what is our baseball record again? Are we 5 losses?
30-5. Yeah.
30-5. So, you mean
that's awful.
That's not a good record.
That's awful.
Pretty bad. And we hired a guy that won 11 games and led us to a Sugar Bowl, correct? Bobby Petrino?
Yeah.
I believe
right.
So.
That's
yeah.
Awful.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then we hired John Calipari. I'm pretty sure he's won a national title in basketball.
He's pretty good.
He's awful, too.
Yeah, pretty bad. I just wanted to give that guy, you know, all the negativity, all the bad things that these hires and the baseball team has done and the basketball team hires been. I just want to point some of the positivity out, and I'll get off here.
Jeez.
Look, nobody pays attention to that stuff anyway.
I don't think so.
No. It's just,
I would think so. Except for Dancing Donkey and
it's humorous.
You his cousins and brothers and everyone else that is there. Snoring Bob says, Randy, why would your wife have to water the plants when you are a rain water?
Whoa, that's a good one. How about that? You know,
plants still take water.
Yeah, but you're a rainwater, so why can't you do it, right? That's a pretty good one.
No. No, I mean, I'm not allowed.
Do you have access to the hose?
No, I am not allowed to touch anything that's outside. Well, because I have been accused with a weed eater of knocking down important things. So I take the attitude that, okay, if you don't want me to do anything, I won't do anything at all. So that's the proper attitude that I maintain.
Great.
I'm kind of like, I'm positive about it. I'm not being negative about it. I'm positive about it. Let's talk with Jack. Jack, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Well, welcome to my world, Randy. my wife, every time I touch the weed eater, I'm cutting down some kind of wildflower.
Yes, that's me.
That she wanted up, or some kind of flower that she planted that looks to me just like a damn weed.
I didn't recognize it. It ain't look like a weed to me.
I mean, if I'm weed eating, hey, just you better look out and get out of my way.
That's,
she's definitely on me about that.
That is sage. That is wonderful wisdom. I will pass it on to my wife that I will continue to use Jack's approach. My approach is the only way to go. The only thing that's worthwhile is what is chopped down.
Well, you do that, Randy, and you see how well that works for you. But anyway, my question is, all right, Calipari has supposedly his first recruit that he signed yesterday, the big 7'2 guy.
Mm-hmm.
When is the dam going to burst? And he starts inking some of these Kentucky blue bloods that he supposedly is bringing with him.
I would say that.
And I'll get off there and let you guys tell me about it, okay?
Thank you, Jack.
There could be, we get Kevin McPherson on today, maybe he can tell us, but I would say next week should be a really good week. I don't know about the rest of this week. But I would think in the next week to 10 days, there'll be more than one player on the roster.
Well, here's another example. And some of this, I think from a player standpoint, this has to be the first step before any coach, much less John Calipari, can do anything about it. But Kentucky commitment Billy Richmond, he reopened his recruitment. It's a 4-star out of New Jersey. So he is just now becoming available. Not all of these players. Example, DJ Wagner. Has he officially put his name into the transfer portal?
Yes.
He has officially put his name in the transfer portal.
It was announced that he did, yeah.
Okay. Because that was only from one day ago, yesterday. So even though I'm guessing you could do Zoom press conference and so forth, that not press conferences, but tours and that kind of stuff, visits. The process, I would be surprised if any of these just go sight unseen with putting their faith into Coach Calipari. But at the same time, I mean, if I'm a student athlete, I want to look around. I want to see the campus. I want to see what's going on.
Well,
and the facilities. Now, my understanding, this happened rather quickly. The headline, this is by Connor Goodson by way of hogsports.com. Arkansas basketball to host nation's top transfer on visit. And that happened to be Omar Ballow. He formerly played at Arizona. He had canceled a scheduled visit to Louisville. However, my understanding is he committed to Ohio State today.
Was it Ohio State that he committed to? He definitely made a commitment today. It was Indiana.
No, Indiana. Right. My bad. Yeah. Indiana.
He's going to Indiana. So he did commit to Indiana.
So today. he didn't visit after it's all said and done. But this correct. Just popped up today.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden now, boom, he's gone. So.
Well, that's it. It's going to be a horrible year.
Don't let the negativity get you down, Rick. Okay.
It's not, believe me.
Okay, don't let it get you down.
Yeah.
These people, okay. This from Posty Paul. I wonder if they're on the road to Damascus. Posty Paul says, the only about doubting Thomas, only thing I doubt is making Thomas happy. Go Hogs. Yeah, then the dancing jungle bunny says, Randy, don't mow over any bluegrass. Doubting Thomas needs to get out of his mamaw's basement and run one out. Okay. This is the year of the Hogs. Okay. Will says, baseball lost another great one today. Whitey Herzog.
Yeah.
Cardinals, an MLB legend who brought some excitement to St. Louis. In the 80s, Whitey Ball is what it was called, and today's baseball is far from it. In today's game, no small ball, bunts, steals, or anything. Elevated swings and no team approach at the plate. Hawks should try that when games come down to the end, getting guys in scoring position, and then moving them on to score. St. Louis lost a good one.
I am. I don't get this. On ESPN, its website, they've got Carl Erskine, who is a pitcher for the Dodgers, last of the Boys of Summer. Those of you who read the book Boys of Summer when it came out several years ago, you know, a great book about the Dodgers. Passed away today. He's 97. Nowhere on the ESPN website that. On their main website that I can find, I'll go to MLB here and see what they say. Okay, Whitey Herzog, it's on their MLB part, but it's not on their main website. I would think a Hall of Fame manager dying
sure.
would be on the main website.
Yeah, you're
same
right.
Same thing with Sports Illustrated. I go to their main website, and, hey, the Rangers are going to call up Al Leiter's son. Michigan's getting penalties for football recruiting. BYU's hiring a Phoenix Suns assistant coach. And Masters TV ratings are down, but there's nothing about Whitey Herzog or Carl Erskine on theirs. And I go to MLB, and let's see. Hall of Famer Whitey Herzog dies. Why do you have to do that? Now, obviously, when you go to the MLB website, it's prominent on there. And when you watch the MLB Network, they're obviously covering it on there. But how can that not be on the ESPN main website? A Hall of Fame manager dies. I don't get that.
It was all over the St. Louis Dispatch, which
well,
you would expect. Yeah.
Yeah, right.
That's where I first learned of it, on the Dispatch.
So Whitey Herzog developed a great friendship with a guy named Joe Bazor, who worked for Cooper Communities and came to Northwest Arkansas, maybe it was even Beaver Lake, and fished frequently. And Bazor would set him up on different lakes to fish. I think he might have come down for an event or two for Norton DeBrien when he was a baseball coach. So just a down-home regular guy who loved the fast-paced game. Even when he managed the Royals, they had several guys that could really run. And with the Cardinals, he had a lot of guys that could run.
Let's talk with Rick. Rick, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Well, man, it's so glad to talk to y'all again. Hey, Randy.
Yes, sir.
I got to get on to you a little bit.
Uh-oh. You've been doing this every time you've been calling lately, Rick.
I know, but it's not bad.
Yeah, you've been wearing me out, but go ahead.
Okay. Now, my wife's got – I'm getting on your side this time. My wife's got this huge flag going around our big place out here. And I'm sorry, I don't take care of it. So So I take care of that. But I do have over 175 plants up right now in my garden. And we do a lot of canning from three generations from her family, and that's our hobby. And so, you know how many killings and we couldn't, I got to do out there on that?
Wow.
It takes every day for me to work at least 2 hours.
Yeah, I started saying that sounds like a full-time job.
I agree with you on the flower garden. I do not work on flowers. Now my main question is, okay, so I know Calipari is going to select his kids because we got all that money. When do you think the team's going to come together? And I'm trying to talk.
Well, they won't come together until next or sometime during the summer because they have to complete their semesters wherever they are. Now, you may see some announcements.
Okay. So that's,
I think you're going to see some announcements. Yeah, you'll see some announcements soon, but they won't come together until the semester is over and they can actually finish their semester in academic good standing.
Right. I think, and then the baseball team, hey, let's peak in Omaha in the regional. That's all I got to say. Hey, y'all are so great. I'm so glad y'all let me in.
Thank you, Rick. You know, and I've asked so many different coaches this over the course of time. I'm sure you have too, Rick. What is the trick to getting your team to peak at the right time? And they'll tell you, if we knew that, we'd bottle it up and make $1 million.
That's right.
So it's very difficult to know when your team is ready to peak or when you can get the team to peak. And certainly we have seen teams that in different sports that never felt like they peaked at any point or time. But one thing is a fact. As long as Arkansas's pitching stays as consistent.
Yeah.
Now they had a couple of shaky moments this past weekend against Alabama. But you take out a shaky performance here and a shaky performance there as a whole, this staff collectively, and I've got it buried in these papers here somewhere, but it's still below 3, which is extraordinary in today's offensive game. So as long as the pitching holds, and I'm still thinking, Rick, there are a few question marks that they're still looking for, still trying to get answered. One of those, who is the closer? Is there a closer? Gackle, yeah. Maybe?
Yeah, I think he is, unless you're in a situation where it just takes 2 innings and Will McIntyre.
Yeah, or McIntyre could go 2 or 3 innings, yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, typically, you're not going to have very many seasons like you had with Kevin Copps. I mean, there was no question. If they could just get the game within a 1 run or maybe sometimes even 2 runs, went into the 8th inning, if need be, Dave would bring him out then. And had confidence in the offense, they'd take the lead and Copps would shut the door. But he tried Faraday. He tried Faraday down in Arlington, had that first night, I guess that was against Oregon State. Boy, looked great. And the next night against, I guess, Oklahoma State, he didn't. So that may be one of the few question marks. And it sounds like, Rick, Davis settled on, for the time being, Peyton Holt in left field.
For the time being. Though we don't know how long that'll be. But, hey, he had a big home run to tie the game on Saturday. And you think about Arkansas's pitching. Okay, so Faraday threw a ball away. They lost 4-3. Mm-hmm. It's not like Alabama slaughtered them. They lost 4-3. The game Sunday was 1-0 until, the 7th inning? And so then they lost 5-0. So in an SEC game on Sunday, normally you figure you're going to score 6 or 7 runs. So the pitching's still fine. We'll see how the non-weekend starters pitch tonight and tomorrow against Texas Tech, a team that scores a lot of runs. But, again, there's so many games left to play. They're halfway through the conference schedule with a record of 12-3. That's really, really good. Overall, 30-5. That's really, really good. Look at the Major League Baseball standings and see if anybody is 12-3. The Yankees were, but they're 12-5 now. In baseball, you don't win every game, no matter how good you are.
All right, let's see. And Rick, you might be able to answer this one. This from our bus text line from Miss Linda. She says, do we know for certain what Battle's plans are?
No, we don't.
Hadn't heard anything, Miss Linda.
No, don't think so.
All right, we will step away for a moment. Rick Schaefer, and I'm Randy Rainwater, Drive Time Sports. We'll continue in just one moment.
Listen every Wednesday when R.J. Hawk joins his old buddies on Morning Mayhem. Presented by Natural State Wholesale Flooring. See everything that Natural State Wholesale has to offer at naturalstatewholesale.com.
Did you know that Mosquito Joe now installs mosquito misting systems? It's the ultimate solution for mosquito-free living. Mosquito Joe's cutting-edge misting systems are discreetly installed around areas such as pools, patios, and boat docks to create a protective barrier that banishes those annoying bugs. It's like having a mosquito control technician in your yard 24/7. Take back your outdoor space this summer by visiting arkansas.mosquitojoe.com. With Mosquito Joe, outside is fun again.
Coach Kevin Kelly joins The Zone each Wednesday, presented by Wooded Rock Athletic Club. The indoor pickleball facility is now open. Join the club today and save 30% off joining fees.
Hi, it's Frank Fletcher from the Fletcher Dodge store here in Sherwood. Folks, if you're shopping for a new car or truck, I hope you'll come see us and give us a chance to earn your business. We have huge discounts, 0% financing available, and we'll give you $1,000 over Kelly Blue Book value for your trade-in. Folks, I guarantee you a hassle-free buying experience. And if you've had credit problems in the past, listen to this. We have an easy pre-approval process. Just go to FletcherCredit.com to get started. You can be pre-approved in minutes. It's really not hard. FletcherCredit.com. Folks, we're also still buying cars every day. If you got an old car or truck you want to turn into cash, bring it to Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood and ask for Chris or Andy. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Shop in person or shop online at FletcherDeals.com. Thank you.
It pays to be early. Because at Cracker Barrel, you can get early dinner deals weekdays from 4 till 6 p.m. That includes their signature meatloaf, homestyle chicken, and more, starting at just $8.99. So make tonight an early dinner night.
Tackle your outdoor projects with Greenway Equipment's Lawn Patrol Package. Handling is effortless with the John Deere 1023E's Twin Touch Foot Controls with a hydrostatic transmission and four-wheel drive with power steering. The 60D Driveover Auto Connect Belly Mower makes mowing easy. And the 120R Quick Park Loader is perfect for dirt moving and mulching projects. With 0% APR for 84 months and a 6-year powertrain warranty, it's a deal you can't miss. For more information, head to your local Greenway or visit gogreenway.com. With approved credit, see dealer for details.
Arkansas golf legend John Daly joins the Mayhem each week, brought to you by Genesis of Conway, the future of luxury today, and by Central Arkansas Truck and Trailer, family-owned and operated diesel and truck repair you can trust.
Some people aren't easily inspired. They require a little more craftsmanship, more elegance, more excitement. Some people are inspired and see the future before it's here. They see the GV70 for its selection as a Car and Driver 10 Best, GV80 for its soft quilted leather, reclining and heated second row seats, and for its IIHS top safety rating. What inspires you? The all-new Genesis of Conway, the future of luxury today.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports, live from the Eat My Catfish Studios, where it's much like any of the 7 Eat My Catfish locations, minus the always fresh, delicious food options like the family pack catfish dinners. You're safe at home with Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network.
Drive Time Sports and the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer, I'm Randy Rainwater. We will be joined in a moment by Kevin Bohannon as we go around the horn. Double B's is the spot. I don't need to get that quick gas up, or whether it be to gas and then go inside and grab your favorite snacks and beverages and drinks as you're out and about, because they have such tremendous monthly specials each and every month. It is worth your time because, hey, you can start off at the pump. If you've got your Exxon credit card, you're going to get 10 cents off a gallon at the pump. And with your Double B's rewards card, you can save money on purchases at all the stores and then turn around and use that to buy even more. Because the great specials that I look at each and every day, I'm thinking, savings, savings, savings. 16-ounce Rockstar, 2 for $5. 28-ounce Gatorade, 2 for $5. And I've been talking about this deal, the 12-ounce 7-Up glass bottles, 2 for $3. I mean, I love 7-Up. I love Coca-Cola right out of the bottle. That's the way I grew up. That's the way most of us grew up, with glass, not plastic. So visit your local Double B, start off at the pump, and then go inside and save yourself money and be such a happy camper. That's Double B's, where you gas it, grab it, and go. Make it Double B's.
Baseball season is in full swing, and you don't want to miss a thing. It's time for Around the Horn with Kevin Bohannon. Around the Horn is brought to you by Stanley Wood, Buick, Chevy, GMC, and Scott Wood, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram. And now, it's time for Around the Horn.
Rick, I've got to admit, Kevin is one of the sunshine pumpers who, when he gets on to Twitter, and he's trying to be positive, he's trying to point out the things that maybe people will get off the ledge and not jump into the darkness of wherever. And Kevin, I don't, why do you do that? Do you just like subjecting yourself to the pain that you're going to get from all those wonderful people out there?
You know, I've always wanted to offer a realistic point of view of the way things go, especially in college baseball. So I think that's the biggest reason why I offer a different point of view. It wouldn't necessarily be sunshine pumping, but I get where you're coming from with that. But there's always a different side, especially when things may be looking down after they lose their first series of the weekend. People are going to ask questions. Are the Razorbacks being exposed? Are they, you know, does everybody have the formula for beating them now? So that's the reason why. And that's it in a nutshell. So I like to learn from a lot of people. You, yourself, Rick, I've learned so much from, and take a little bit of that and present the best case so people can make an educated opinion, so to speak.
Now, let's ask this. Is this a trend, or is it something that is a real concern? And it does seem like, as of late, Arkansas has had their issues with left-handed pitching by the opponent.
And if you go back and look at some of Coach Nick Thompson's offenses, they've had trouble with lefties in the past. Now, this team has been a little different this year. I think they've handled left-handed pitching a lot better than some of the teams in the past, mostly because they haven't been a heavy lefty lineup. And now with the expansion of getting a few more players involved in the lineup, Nolan Sousa and Ross Lovich,
Will Evanson,
so there's a few more lefties that have the potential to hit. Now, I think Peyton Holt is going to find a place in the outfield, and you may see him in a different spot tonight. Just a little heads up, and I think that's something that Coach Van Horn really wants to get him in the lineup. That's what we talk about in the preseason. He's the spark plug for that team, and he could be in a certain position. He talked in the preseason about Holt could be a good leadoff for him. They put Diggs in the leadoff in the Sunday game. So I still think that he wants to give Stovall a chance to get more RBIs and kind of get Kendall out of his hole. The reason he put him in the leadoff spot, referring to Kendall Diggs, is get him a few more at-bats, get him to see pitching, and see if he can break out of slump. He's hitting 264 right now. That's low for Kendall. He should be hitting 320, 330. No problem. So they're going to get it tested. And this was – the back half of the schedule was always going to be the toughest part of them. I said if they could get through the South Carolina series over 30 wins, they were going to be in a great position because the back half of the schedule was going to be brutal with Texas A&M, Kentucky, Florida. Now, Florida has fallen off, but Kentucky is really taking their place as the top team in the East. So you just changing one for another. And then Texas A&M, who's the number one team in the nation right now, hitting the ball. I mean, there's no easy outs in their lineup, and they have guys that can get you out. So a lot will be learned over the next couple of weeks, especially the next two nights, because Texas Tech, they can hit. May not be able to defend and pitch. They can hit. They're hitting 324 as a team. 65 home runs as a team. They got four guys that have 30 or more RBIs. That's where Arkansas only has one.
Well, I would say that if Arkansas is suffering and if this is going to be problematic, then Vanderbilt's season's over. They got swept last weekend, so Vanderbilt's pretty well done. And
yeah.
Texas A&M's going to Alabama this weekend, and if they're number one, so if somehow Alabama beats them two out of three, they're done. You can throw them out. So who else, is Oregon State next? Are they going to win it all since all these good SEC teams aren't really any good anymore?
Yeah, I mean, you have four of the top five teams in the nation are in the
yes!
SEC right now.
That means some of them beat each other. Isn't that amazing?
Yeah. You're going to have those weekends. And listen, this fan base was looking for a glimmer of hope when baseball season started, and they latched onto it. Then they started having – recollection of 2021 where Arkansas went through the whole season, won every series.
Yeah.
Won 15 straight. You're not going to do that every year. You're not going to do that every other year, every 3 years. So let's go back to 2018. The stat lines and the way these teams are built mirror each other. I saw a good stat line on that last night, the way they hit, run, pitch, everything. So if you want to kind of glimpse back to 2018, that team, and I'm saying this team will make the College World Series Finals, but this team has the potential to do it based on their longevity. We don't want to flash in the pan or peaking at the wrong time, and I still don't think they're peaking at the wrong time. Like I said last week, if you've got half of your guys that are hitting, look, hitting let them down last weekend and the pitching wasn't perfect. Pitching has been close to perfect, and it's bailed the offense out sometimes. Now it's time for the offense to start bailing out the pitchers.
Makes it a lot easier, and you got something to work with, and always looking to score.
Yeah, Hagan Smith was in the perfect position on Friday night. He got spotted three runs in the first and then two in the second. Hagan Smith pitching with a five-run lead, I would put Tessa's college fund on that. I didn't, but I would.
Well, it only became endangered because the bullpen gave up a few runs here and there. All right, you teased a little bit about Peyton Holt. It sounded like the other day, coming out of the Alabama series, that he was the new left fielder, at least as Rick said, for the time being. Are you suggesting that he might be somewhere else than left field tonight for the Arkansas Razorbacks?
Could be. I know that he's worked out in different places in the outfield, so I think they want to find him a spot to where he can be productive as a defender, which he showed that he can do that last weekend. The catch he made up against the wall, that's next level stuff. That's next level instincts as an outfielder. That's stuff you can't teach. So let's move him around. The only spot he's not going to play, guys, is right field. So take from that what you will. I think that he will get a chance to play another position out there.
Kevin, don't you agree with Kendall? Often when you begin to believe that you're in a slump, you start chasing.
And it appears to me that Kendall Diggs is swinging at pitches that when he's going good, he doesn't even think about swinging the bat, taking a shot at that particular pitch. And maybe he's gotten fooled a little bit more than he has maybe in times past. But wouldn't you believe right now the one thing that Nate is trying to stress to Kendall Diggs is pitch selection?
That's exactly right. And that's the one thing that Diggs has always been, even back to his freshman year, he was always a good, disciplined hitter. He could take two strikes and then hit the third one, hit it for a double, hit it down the line, hit it out of the park. He needs to get back into that. As we know, 90% of this game is mental. So talking with Kendall and getting him back in the position where he needs to be, and it's kind of like some of the pitchers. Will McIntyre had a bad weekend. Now, does that mean that Willie Mack is going to, you know, fall to the back of the bullpen line? Absolutely not. He's shown a body of work that the coaching staff can rely on. So it's the same thing with Diggs. He needs to get out there, see some pitches. He will hit a lot tonight and tomorrow night. I would bet the bank on it. So he needs to get in there, see pitches, lefty and righty, so he can get more comfortable. If he needs to go back to, you know, take, hit, that's something that he needs to get comfortable with. If he's in there and he's thinking too much, he's already beat.
What about center field? Wilsmeyer is not hitting. I don't know what he weighs, but he's got to be getting close to not even hitting his weight right now. What does Dave do about the center field position?
That's right at the Mendoza line. It's 209 right there. So, you know, you see that they put Will Edmondson out there a little bit more. That's where I think you may concede a Peyton Holt. You know, can they do that? Can they work him in out there, get him comfortable for the back half of the SEC run right here over the next 4 weeks? That's something that they're going to have to work with him with, because center field is the toughest part. You have the most area to cover, and you have to read spin every which direction. You do in right and left too, but center field's hard. It's not the easiest job to just, you know, throw out there. A lot of people were saying, look, hey, can we put Nolan Sousa out there? No, you just can't throw an infielder in the outfield just to get his bat in the lineup. Holt is that kind of athlete, though, and he's been working out there. So I think Peyton Holt, Will Edmondson, I think they will get the majority of the reps out there between and working Lovich too. Odd man, I think Edmondson's a little bit better in center than Lovich is. So it may be an Edmondson-Holt thing in center field, depending on the pitcher.
Does that mean the other is in left, or does that mean that Lovich gets a shot in left?
That means, Lovich and the odd man's out
there
in left field.
All right. Rick Schaefer, I'm Randy Rainwater. We'll continue with Kevin Bohannon in just one moment. Drive Time Sports will continue after this timeout.
For the 20th annual Double B's BuzzBQ, Saturday, May 11th at the downtown Riverside RV Park in North Little Rock. Go to buzzbq.com.
The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics. Hey, everybody, it's RJ Hawk. You know, I've been talking about this for a long time, and I say the future's here. You just haven't tried it yet. If you've got achy joints that have been nagging you for a long time, don't go to a doctor and have them recommend surgery or drugs. Go by and give QC Kinetics a try today for a free consultation. They are the nation's leader in the most exciting revolution in pain management we've seen in decades. It's called regenerative medicine. If your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. We're talking natural biologics using your own body's power to repair and restore your damaged tissue. QC Kinetics is under the leadership of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Scheinkup. He is a pioneer in the field with 20 years of clinical work, tons of research, teaching, and publishing. Call QC Kinetics now to learn about these exciting options. It's a free consultation. 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440.
What do you do when the power goes out? Well, now you can do anything you want when you purchase a Generac home standby generator from Generator Supercenter of Little Rock. Come visit the experts at Central Arkansas's only generator showroom located on Chenal Parkway in West Little Rock. We offer a turnkey solution, financing, and 24/7 service. Visit our website for more info at GeneratorSupercenterOfLittleRock.com. The standby power people.
Sea-Doo sales event now at all Bradford Marine and ATV locations. Check out the 2023 Sea-Doo Explorer 170 with $500 in extra discounts and as low as 0.99% financing.
Always wear appropriate protective clothing and a coaster-approved PFE that is suitable for PWC use. Always ride safely and responsibly. Remember that riding, alcohol, and drugs don't mix.
It's a good day to be in Arkansas. You know why? The Lotto jackpot is now more than $1.5 million. And the best part? The winning ticket can only be sold in Arkansas. Maybe today. Maybe even to you. Can you imagine? There's a jackpot drawing every Wednesday and Saturday night. So your next chance to win is coming up very soon. Try Lotto today for only $2 per play. Call 1-800-522-4700 for Problem Gambling Helpline.
Pickup truck, sports car, motorcycle, minivan, townhouse, two-story, farmhouse, fixer-upper. What you drive and where you live is different for everyone, so it's important to have insurance that fits your needs and is just right for you. At Shelter Insurance, we understand that, which is why our agents help you design a comprehensive auto, home, and life insurance plan. Insurance that fits just right.
See Shelter agent Christy Pettit in Maumelle, Matt Cooper in Russellville, or Madison Buse in England.
Crawfish season is finally back at Eat My Catfish. We've got fresh, live crawfish, and all you have to do is just add the fixins. Be sure to come see us or order online at eatmycatfish.com. Eat local, eat fresh, eat my catfish.
Live from the Eat My Catfish studios, you feed your crave for sports by listening to Drive Time Sports. Much like you feed your crave at any of the 7 Eat My Catfish locations. You're in hog heaven. This is Drive Time Sports, a presentation of the Buzz Radio Network.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports. You're in the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer, I'm Randy Rainwater. We'll be rejoined by Kevin Bohannon as we go around the horn. Thanks again to the Witt Family Dealerships. But first, I want to talk to Neil Atkinson by way of Bet Saracen. Neil, this is a intriguing matchup tonight between Arkansas and Texas Tech.
Absolutely. We know that because we are sitting here fighting with these double R specials and trying to pick where we're going to benchmark and get my risk in trading to price them where they're attractive. It's just really, really, really tough right now. So, hey, I think they'll get back on track tonight. At least we hope they do. The money line, Arkansas's -175, so just a favorite. And if you want to give up 2.5 runs, it's only -1.5. So over and under is 13.5. So
that's a lot of runs. That's a lot of runs.
Runs and a little weather in the area. I think more so down this way, but. We got that, and don't forget, tonight's the start of the NBA play-in tournament. So we've got that up there. There's a couple of specials you want to check out, some interesting ones. We've got the last 2 days of the regular hockey season. And, of course, Major League Baseball is in full swing. We've got daily specials there and a coverage of all those games. No rest for the weary because as soon as we get done with March Madness, we're right in the playoff season with the NBA and hockey. So getting ready to wrap those up, and it'll be the boys of the summers in the Olympic and golf. So there you go.
Barely get one put to bed. Here's another one. And you had the WNBA draft last night. And as you mentioned, the play-in games began with the NBA. So there's a lot of action you'll find on Bet Saracen. So where does someone go, Neil, to get all this good stuff?
Hey, on your phone, go to the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store. Just type in Bet Saracen. You can look at all of our specials and our content without logging in. I'm sure you'll find something. Click that register button in as little as 5 minutes. It can be verified, making a deposit, and betting on your favorite team, player, or sport.
Outstanding. Thank you, Neil. That is Neil Atkinson by way of Bet Saracen. Go get the app in the App Store, or better yet, you can also go online at BetSaracen.com.
Baseball season is in full swing, and you don't want to miss a thing. It's time for Around the Horn with Kevin Bohannon. Around the Horn is brought to you by Stanley Wood, Buick, Chevy, GMC, and Scott Wood Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. And now, it's time for Around the Horn.
All right, Kevin, I want to squeeze this in real quick because we always seem to run out of time. It is not yet the playoffs, but it's getting mighty close in high school baseball. There's going to be some conference championships, which determines seedings, whether it be in regionals or even for that matter, later on in state tournament play. So we're getting down to the crunch time for high school baseball.
That's exactly right, Double R. If you look at Class 3A, you've already got some conference champions. Harding Academy's clinched, CAC, Central Arkansas Christian has clinched, Boonville has clinched outright with their win last night over Cossatot River. So Elkins in the 1-3A, a lot of the 3A conferences are already decided. Woodlawn's playing really well right now. Riverside and Rector in the 3-2A will go at tonight. Riverside beat Rector last week, 6-0. Riverside, of course, one of the top teams in Class 2A in our Natural State Sports Arkansas Preps Weekly Super 7 poll. You can go to naturalstatesports.com to check out our Super 7 rankings. The top teams are still the top teams, Randy. And Woodlawn's 22-1, but Riverside's right behind them right now. Riverside beat Walnut Ridge, who's one of the top teams in 3A. Walnut Ridge is 19-4 on the season now. Nolan Belcher last week switched his commitment from Arkansas State to the University of Kentucky. So Kentucky now has three of the last seven recruiting cycles plucked the player out of the state of Arkansas. So SEC is coming to the state and getting players that aren't going to go to Arkansas. So just makes for a lot of good baseball here. And you go to Class 6A, what a run Rogers Heritage has had. They're 21-0 in the season now. They beat Fayetteville 7-2 last night. They can stay in first place in the 6A West, which is, you know, pretty congested at the top. We're looking for another Rogers Heritage rivalry for the conference title. And then Springdale Harbor and Fayetteville are right behind them. But the 6A West is still up for grabs. You got Bryant, Cabot up there at the top, and then Catholic and Conway shortly behind them. Valley View and Greene County Tech were scheduled to play tonight for the 5A East title. I say title. They're both 8-0. They're the only undefeated teams. They're two games clear of the third and fourth place team. So those teams are going to decide the 5A East. Valley View came to Little Rock last week on Friday. They beat Little Rock Christian 13-3. That's right, 13-3. Mm. Number one versus number two, rematch of last year's state title game. And neither team threw their ace, but Valley View threw Jade Taylor, the junior who started for the Blazers in the outfield last year, and he got up to 91. And that's a kid that doesn't pitch very much for him. That just shows you how deep that Blazers pitching staff is. Lake Hamilton's looking really good in the 5A South. They're 17-2 on the season now. And Greenwood's still at the top of the 5A West. Class 4A, Lone Oak and Joe T. Robinson, not Plasky Robinson. Joe T. Robinson, they play at Robinson tonight in a doubleheader. That'll decide the 5-4A conference title. And just a lot of good stuff still to figure out. The 1-4A up in Rick's part of the world is still kind of crazy. Shiloh Christian kind of on top right now, but you got about five teams that are right there within a game. Still a lot to figure out before conference tournament time.
Is Valley View, they were they not at one point nationally ranked? Are they nationally ranked?
Yeah, depending on who you talk to. They got up as high as, I think, 18 in perfect games poll. Then they lost, so they dropped a little bit. But they're still in the top 30. Baseball America may have them ranked. Collegiate Baseball Newspaper puts out a high school poll. I usually go by the perfect game rankings because they're really consistent with what they do. They'll put them out once every 2 weeks. I think they do a top 50 nationally. And they're spot on with a lot of the guys like myself can report to those guys and say, hey, this is who you need to look at in our state, in our region, who can make noise on the national level. And they were undefeated until Magnolia Heights beat them on that Saturday a couple weeks ago, but they bounced back really well. And they're going to be in the conversation for best team in Arkansas history by the time it's done. They got to take it one day at a time, like Coach Allison has told those guys. It's one practice at a time, one pitch at a time. If they take care of everything in between, the outcome, the process will take care of that.
Is this the one pitching staff, K,
Kevin, that has not one, but several who are topping 90 miles per hour?
Yeah, so Lance Davis is the 2024 Arkansas signee. He's been over 90. Eli Cresselius, who works upper 80s, 86 to 88, can throw at 90. Lawson Ward is going to Arizona State as a pitcher. He's been 90 and above. Jade Taylor's number four. I'm sure Coach Matt Snyder would get me. He's the pitching coach for those guys. Me and Matt are really close. But then you got Slade Caldwell, he works mid-80s, 85, 86. I'm sure he could throw at 90 if he wanted to. So if you got five guys and you got three that can consistently work in that 88 to 91 range, it's going to be tough on a lot of hitters.
That's amazing.
What classification. Yeah, no matter what classification you're at.
That is simply amazing. All right, so what conferences are going to be determined this week? You mentioned Robinson, Lone Oak, that's one. Any others to name real quick?
Yeah, the 3-2A, Riverside and McCrory, they still got to play. Riverside and Rector, excuse me. McCrory and Palestine Wheatley will get to play again. Still got some things to work out in the 6-2A, that's the 6-2A, McCrory and Palestine Wheatley. Those are the big ones right now. The 1-4A is still in the 7-4A with Nashville, Magnolia, Ashdown. There's four teams within a game and a half of each other down there. So still a couple of conferences down there in the South Arkansas in the 8 and 7-4A. We still need to see some ball games, so that'll work itself out for conference tournament action.
All right, safe travels, Kevin. We'll talk with you later on this week. That is Kevin Bohannon.
Thanks, guys.
As we go around the horn. Thanks again at the Wood Family Dealerships. Rick Schaefer, I'm Randy Rainwater. Coming up next, Trey Biddy, hogsports.com, being brought to you by Chris Crane Hyundai and Genesis of Conway. Hour number two, straight ahead.
Love off-roading? There's a 2024 Chevy Silverado Trail Boss at Guatney Chevrolet ready for a driver. It's got improved shocks and suspension, plus wheels made for the off-road. You can make it yours for as low as $61,905. Call, click, or come visit Guatney Chevrolet to hear about our available rebates, and we'll make you the boss of the trail. Come see us in Jacksonville or visit GuatneyChevrolet.com. Chevrolet, together, let's drive.
There are no ordinary days in Arkansas. Hike to inspiring summits, bike on world-class trails, or fish in sparkling waters. Or see some of the world's top art collections and explore historic sites dedicated to everything from civil rights to rock and roll. After that, eat some award-winning barbecue and sip a local craft beer. So go on, get out there, and explore what the natural state has to offer. Find out more at Arkansas.com.
Tickets are on sale now for the 20th annual Double B's BuzzBQ, Saturday, May 11th at the downtown Riverside RV Park in North Little Rock. Go to buzzbq.com.
ESPN and The Buzz gives you the complete sports and entertainment package.
I love that game.
103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock.
Buzz News with KARK's Claire Kreitz.
The report from the Arkansas Legislative Audit over the governor's $19,000 lectern has finally been released. The report shows the governor's office was potentially non-compliant with state laws in seven areas. That includes paying for the lectern before it was delivered, capitalizing it as an operating expense, and improper record keeping. The governor's office called the audit deeply flawed. The 6th Judicial District prosecuting attorney and the attorney general are reviewing the report. Methodist Family Health is celebrating 125 years. The organization has created new home and hope for all throughout difficult times during war and the Great Depression. Over the years, the facility has expanded to provide not only short-term care, but also treatment and therapy options for the whole family. This is Claire Kreitz for the Buzz Radio Network.
For interior, exterior, commercial, and residential painting, hire the pros at Serta Pro Painters. Get your free estimate at CertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center
with KARK's Juliana Cullen.
Breezy, cloudy, and warm weather on the way for the rest of your Tuesday. Also have the chance for a couple isolated showers and storms to develop throughout the afternoon and evening hours. And there is a low-end risk for a few of these storms to be on the strong to severe side. Also have some rain lingering overnight tonight. This was meteorologist Juliana Cullen with the Arkansas Storm Team for the Buzz Radio Network.
buy one, get one free at the Riverfront Steakhouse. This Thursday night, we're going to have prime rib, 12 ounces of prime rib, served with all the mashed potatoes you can eat. Buy one, get one free.
Hey! Saturday. Oh my gosh, John Denny was great. Great to have Justin Moore back. Rick Schaefer was all over.
Peyton Stovall.
Peyton Stovall was outstanding. Tomorrow we'll be at Luxury Pool and Spa. Their big annual sale, 20% off everything in the store in Conway. Plus, Craig O'Neill.
Hannah Gamble.
Boom, that's all you need. Morning Mayhem. Hey, it's David Basil, and the annual Luxury Pool and Spa 20% off store-wide sale is going on now through this Saturday. Don't miss it. This sale includes everything store-wide, including patio furniture by Fisco, rebates on Pool Life and Bakwasil pool chemicals, and even spas like the one I have at my house are discounted lower than truckload pricing. Daily giveaways include PK Grills and Luxury Pool and Spa $150 gift cards. It's a 20% off store-wide sale going on now through Saturday at Luxury Pool and Spa in Conway and Russellville. Check them out online at luxurypoolarkansas.com.
Smith & Wesson revolvers are built to suit the demands of the most serious firearms enthusiast. And for a limited time at Max Prairie Wings in Stuttgart, receive a $50 rebate on Smith & Wesson J-frame revolvers or a $75 rebate on Smith & Wesson K-frame, L-frame, N-frame, and Governor revolvers. This offer expires April 30th, so hurry before time runs out. Max Prairie Wings, with the best selection, the most competitive prices, and all the ammo you need. So make the short drive to Stuttgart today or online at maxpw.com.
Hello, Buzz listeners. It's Chris Zender, and I've got some big news. Fletcher Dodge has big discounts on all new Rams, up to $11,000 off new Ram 2500s and up to $10,000 off new half-ton Rams. But that's not all. We got 0% financing on new Ram Bighorns for 72 months. Yes, I said 0% for 72 months. Or how about $10,000 off new Jeep Gladiators? And we have the new 2024 Jeep Compass four-wheel drives for only $424 a month with zero down and no gimmicks. We're getting new inventory every week, so come in and let us know what you're looking for. We're ready to make a deal. We have pre-owned vehicles starting as low as $199 a month at zero down. Don't worry about your credit. If other dealers have told you no, come see us or apply from anywhere at FletcherCredit.com. Fast, easy, and simple approval process. And let us help you get into a new or pre-owned vehicle. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Come see us in person at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood or shop online at FletcherDeals.com.
Pay attention. This happens fast. You need money. You get a job. Turns out that job doesn't pay near enough for the nonsense it puts you through every day. You want to move fast, but the clock moves slow. You're smart, though. You know machines. You want to work at a place as fast as you. You call Medley Equipment Company. They need a technician, and they'll teach you everything you need to know to be the best. With pay raises all along. Because Medley keeps you moving.
I'm branch manager Jeff Tess. Visit MedleyCompany.com or come see us at 121 House Court, North Little Rock, Arkansas.
Yep, that's the sounds of all my friends and another great deck party of mine. And what do you not hear? That's right, no mosquitoes. That's because Sanders Ground Essential provides me with a monthly mosquito barrier spray. Call them at 315-9395 or on the web at sandersground.com.
Is your Oaklawn Thoroughbred racing action so close you can feel it? Or is it the view from your trackside luxury suite? However you like it, racing season is off and running at Oaklawn with live races every weekend through May 4th. It's fun by the furlong all season long. Make your reservations today at oaklawn.com. What's your Oaklawn? Gambling problem? Call 1-800-522-4700.
Make this summer one to remember by stopping by Arch Marine in North Little Rock. Arch is all about creating fun on our lakes and rivers. You have to come by and see the new 2024 G3 Tritoons, the hottest and coolest ride out there. We're easy to find. Take the Levy exit.
Are you in a constant battle with mosquitoes outside your house? Well, stop smacking yourself in the face and call Mosquito Joe. Whether the kids are playing in the yard or if you're just cooking out with friends, Mosquito Joe treatments allow you to enjoy your yard without the nuisance of pesky mosquitoes, ticks, and fleas. No more itching and no more wasting time on smelly bug sprays that don't work. Visit arkansas.mosquitojoe.com to get more information and a free quote. With Mosquito Joe, outside is fun again.
Live from the Eat My Catfish studios, it's time for Arkansas's number one caller-driven sports show.
It's Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network with your hosts, Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer. Lock it in and get ready to dial us up. Drive Time Sports is on the air.
Hour number two at Drive Time Sports in the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer standing by in Northwest Arkansas. I'm Randy Rainwater from the Capital City.
And now, Trey Biddy is brought to you by Chris Crane Hyundai, Arkansas's number one Hyundai dealer, and Genesis of Conway, Arkansas's only Genesis dealer. Genesis of Conway, the future of luxury today. Now, here's Trey Biddy.
Good afternoon, Trey.
Hey, guys.
I think what is confusing to some is the transfer portal for the spring opened up yesterday, and it goes through the 30th of April. That's the window for those that want to put their name into the transfer portal. But that does not mean that they have to make a decision by April the 30th. That could extend beyond April the 30th. So I think it's kind of confusing. You think, okay, a name went in there. That means he's got to make his decision in, like, now.
Right, right. You have plenty of time. And, you know, that's one reason I think the portal window, even in the winter, should probably be shrunk, because do you really need that much time to decide if you're going to hit the portal or not?
Right.
You know, you're sitting there as a coach, you're just wondering for the next 30 days, it was 45, you know, whether or not you're going to have guys enter the portal. Is that right? Is it 45 or was it 60 and then 45 or 45 and 30? I can't even keep up with it because they've changed so much the last few years. But, yeah, I don't feel like you need that much time to decide whether or not you're going to enter the transfer portal. But, yes, you got a couple of weeks here, and then there's time after that that you can, you know, end up with a school. So the window is for getting in the portal. It doesn't have anything to do with getting out of it.
And let's see. This from our Buzz text line from Miss Linda. She says, when Trey comes on, please ask if he thinks there's a chance we might be able to keep Battle, Mark, and Blocker as Razorbacks. Well, Mark is gone. He's headed to the University of Texas, which is interesting. Two of their starters have now opted out over the last 48 hours, so I guess you're doing addition by subtraction if you're the University of Texas. I've heard nothing on Battle. I have heard nothing on Blocker.
It feels like a clean start, doesn't it, Randy?
Right.
It does.
Yeah, I feel like there. I feel like it'll be. By the way, I ran into Miss Lisa on Saturday.
Miss Linda. This is Miss Linda.
I mean, sorry, Miss. Oh, Miss Linda. Okay,
she wasn't
no,
hurt.
I didn't meet
she?
Miss Linda. I met Miss Lisa.
she wasn't hurt, was she?
Yeah.
When you ran into her.
Oh, here we go. Oh, no. No, I met Miss Lisa. Sorry, not Miss Linda.
Good. Yeah. Good.
That's going to be confusing, Miss Linda and Miss Lisa now. So, but yeah, I feel like it'll be a clean slate. I don't think you'll see anybody from last year's team on this year's.
I agree with you. I think if that was going to happen, I think it would have already happened, even in spite of no longer than Coach Calipari has been on the job. Let's see here.
When do you think, Trey, that he'll announce? I mean, CBS Sports has already said four of his assistants are coming with him. When do you think Arkansas will announce that, or is it necessary? In recruiting, they just go ahead and recruit whether they're announced or not.
We've seen it with football time and time again, where we'll just see, you know, somebody will be out on the road, or a recruit will say, hey, it was great. You know, it was great meeting Coach Pittman and, you know, so-and-so. You know, so we've seen in the past where it's just like we find out that way. But, yeah, his staff is I guess, pretty well, you know, getting put together. right now it's, by the way, Randy, just a quick correction. It's April 16th. Today was the first day that the portal window opened. So it closed yesterday and it opens today.
Okay.
It's 16th through 30. That's why you didn't see any activity yesterday aside from people saying, hey, I'm going to enter the portal. And then today you saw some names actually pop up in the portal. But no, I mean, like we've seen coaches in the past and, you know, football particular, like, you know, not have the full staff together and go out and start recruiting and, you know, kind of piece it together as it goes along. But I'm actually surprised. I figured we'd maybe have another. I kind of, you know, thought maybe we'd get a commitment a day over the next 13 days or something as this roster fills out. But so far it's just a Visich. So, which is a really nice get. I mean, that's a heck of a way to start things off.
Let's see, this also, Trey, from the Buzz text line, Miles Slusher entered the transfer portal again. Any interest from the Hogs?
Maybe there could be. I don't know. I felt like Slusher kind of left upset. I don't think he'll be back. I could be wrong, but I don't think he'll be back.
Let's see.
I do think that they could use a safety. I think they need a safety, as we talked about yesterday, a safety, two linebackers, two defensive tackles, two offensive linemen. I think those are the priorities. Right now, for those wondering, they have seven spots available on the scholarship roster. The max is 85, so they've got 78. And nothing has changed today with Andrew Chambly officially entering. We were already counting him. Jashad Stewart officially entering. We were already counting him. Who else? Jacoby Criswell entered, counted him just recently. Isaiah Gustav entered. Francis Sherman, I don't know if he entered today or not. I can't remember. But, you know, we'd already counted him off the roster. He wasn't returning. So, no new changes right now as far as football goes. So it was overall pretty uneventful as far as, you know, football players entering the portal or anybody committing to Arkansas, which, again, can happen well after the 30 if it works out that way. But, yeah, that's not too much going on for football today. It'll happen, though. There'll be plenty of news. There's 12 spots to fill in basketball and 7 in football right now. So plenty of stuff coming.
I'm sure you do the same. Well, maybe not. You may just lean upon your 247 network, but I started my daily search of all the different websites that I have. This one from the Knoxville News. Tennessee linebacker Elijah Herring, who was the Volunteers' top tackler, he has entered the transfer portal. He had 80 tackles last year, 4 for a loss, started 12 games at the middle linebacker spot, and he was limited this spring by injuries, but he has put his name into the transfer portal. And Rick and I were talking earlier this afternoon, and he said there is a linebacker from Florida, University of Florida, who has put his name into the transfer portal. So, Trey, there are your two linebackers.
Yeah, I mean, technically the SEC has a rule that restricts interconference transfers during the spring. I don't know how you restrict that anymore. I don't know how you enforce that anymore. But
yeah.
And what I don't understand about the rule is, like, why would you want quality players from your conference going and building the rosters of ACC schools or Big Ten or Big 12 schools?
I think if I can get, as Rick is all often saying, time and time again, if there's a Georgia player, if there's an Alabama player, go get them.
That's right. Go get them.
that's what Rick's always saying. Go get them. Mm-hmm. So I had forgotten. I didn't remember the restriction on wanting to take transfers from inside the SEC during the spring. I didn't remember that one.
So here's the rundown of the rule of note. The SEC has a rule that restricts interconference transfers during the spring. You can do it winter only. Such players would have to sit out a a season. The way the conference is getting away with the statute is players are not barred from leaving their current school for another and may be and be immediately eligible. So that's the rule.
Wow.
That applies to Oklahoma and Texas now.
That means there's going to be a lot of good players then from the SEC that's going to be leaving the SEC.
It's not a good rule.
No,
it's not.
It's not a good rule, and it doesn't – like, I think it would probably be beaten in court.
I agree.
So, but, yeah, why would you want, you know, a guy like that linebacker to be playing at Ohio State instead of an SEC school?
Tony, good afternoon. You got a question or comment for Trey?
Yes, Randy. How you guys doing today?
Man, doing great. Thank you, Tony.
I was wanting to know if we're going to try to get another field goal kicker, and I'll hang up and listen. Guys, have a good
one. Thank you, Tony.
Well, it wasn't a great day for – it was a good day for punters. It wasn't a great day for field goal kickers in the red-white game, but I don't know that they're going to go out and spend a scholarship on another field goal kicker. No, I don't think that'll happen. So, it's – I mean, Arkansas – I think Shipley probably an average, maybe above average SEC kicker, and he's not Cam Little. There's not a lot of Cam Littles out there. I mean, there's probably two kickers that have a chance to get drafted in the NFL draft this year, so there's not a lot of guys out there like that who are NFL kickers in college football. Those guys who are good kickers tend to stay in the league for a long time. There's only 32 starting kickers, so there's just not a lot of talents like that in college. And Arkansas was lucky to have Cam, but it's not just going to go out and find a replacement for Cam Little.
All right, Trey, this from the Buzz text line from Earl says, ask
Give
Trey.
Give me something so I don't shut down. Something I don't – everything you've given me, Randy, I've shut it down.
Well, I don't know that you can shut this one down. So Earl's saying, ask Trey, has he heard anything about Ronnie Brewer Jr.?
I have not. I'm hoping. I've heard some people suggest that there's a good chance he could stay on staff. I think it's important to keep somebody from Arkansas. So I've heard that there is a chance that he would remain on staff, and we'll see what happens. But I think that would be a good one. I think that would be a good move to keep him in Arkansas, considering he knows this state and is from here, you know, and is also a high-quality coach.
All right, Trey, this from the 501, Braylon Russell. Is he shaping up to be the number two running back?
I could see that happening before it's all said and done, yeah. And the thing with Braylon is he's extremely powerful. He's got great size, and he is pretty fast. Mm-hmm. I mean, He moves pretty well, and it'll surprise you at first when you see him, and then you see him run the ball. So I think Braylon's got a chance to have a really good career at Arkansas, and he just has so much ability. I've talked about, I mean, anybody who watched the red-white game on TV who hasn't seen him in person, you know, I don't even know if it does it justice, but this kid's thighs are like two of mine. I mean,
he's a big man.
Yeah, he is put together, and he reminds me a lot of ways of, like, Darius Howard, but, like, a few inches taller, you know. Like, he's, you know, probably 6'1", maybe even 6'2". He's a big dude, but he's kind of like Darius was, but, like, magnified a little bit. So.
All right, Trey, this from the 501 from our Buzz text line. Is that rule, speaking of the interconference transferring a no-no during the spring, is that rule to prevent SEC from tampering, essentially? Well, if that's the case, they need to do it year-round.
Yeah,
because tampering goes on year-round.
It has no. There's not a rule out there that's prevented people from tampering, I assure you that.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I don't know why the rule is in place. Maybe to discourage them from transferring? I don't know.
Good question.
Well, and how long ago was that rule written? That's the question, is how long ago was it written? And, yeah, maybe at the spring meetings they need to change it.
Been around for a while, though, hadn't it?
Well, that's what I mean. If it's been around for a while, things have changed so dramatically, it's maybe time to get rid of that one.
Now, I don't know. Does that rule apply? I don't know if that rule applies to grad transfers, though.
Hmm.
Well, it shouldn't.
Get them a degree real quick.
Got a degree in a year and a half. How about that?
That's easy at some of these SEC schools to get them.
All right, Trey, this from the 870. With Bale's performance in the spring game, is he now the number one punter?
No, I mean, Fletcher has actually a bigger leg than Bale. Bale kicked the tar out of the ball in the spring game. I mean, he's done that. I mean, like, when you go out and watch him in practice, there were times where I was like, oh, Max Fletcher got a hold of that one, because I know that Max can boom it, and it would be Devin Bale. So Arkansas has two really good punters on the roster. But Fletcher just has – he's got just a little something extra. Like, he kicks the ball higher and farther than when he gets a hold of it than anybody I've ever seen up here. And wow. They've had some good punters. Mm-hmm. When Fletcher gets a hold of it, like, and I'm in the press box, it'll go up like eye level. I mean, it's high. Now, he was actually all SEC last year, you guys. I mean, he was second team all SEC. We remember the shanks. He really struggled his freshman year. I mean, really struggled. And then was better last year. Still had a shank here and there. But was much better, much more consistent, and I would expect him to take another step forward. I think Arkansas is in pretty good shape at punter, and, you know, field goal kicker might be a little bit of an area for concern.
Can either one of those be a place kicker?
Well, they've got Vito Calvaruso back. Remember Vito?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Vito can kick it out of the back kicker. Of the end zone.
He's a kickoff guy, yeah.
Right. Yeah, Vito will spray it all over the place when he's kicking field goals, but kickoffs he can get him through the back.
And by the way, if Fletcher's ever having a bad day, they got a guy that can bail him out.
Felt that one coming.
Yeah, me too.
Thunder Buzz, good afternoon. You have a question or comment for Trey?
Yes, sir. I was wondering if there's any talk about Todd Day maybe joining the staff of Coach Calipari with his ties to Memphis and – being a Razorback, and, you know, I know he's a high school coach over there. I just going to see what the comments was on that.
That's the first I've heard anybody suggest that. I don't know why, but, like, I've heard Todd Day, obviously Ronnie Brewer is a former player and has been in coaching. Somebody suggested Joe Johnson today to me. I don't know why everybody's mentioning former Razorbacks. I mean, I guess I know why, but – I have not heard anything that would suggest Todd Day.
He is at Philander Smith, by the way.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's what I thought.
Philander Smith. Let's see. This from Tanner and Conway by way of our Buzz text line. How much does the spring game actually tell coaches/players about potential playing time and impact decisions to enter the transfer portal shortly thereafter? That from Tanner.
I think they probably got a pretty good idea before the spring game what they're going to do. I know that they do. I don't know that the spring game is the big deciding factor on, you know, I mean, there is some things for, like, depth and stuff like that. But, I mean, guys, they've made very little changes to this depth chart from the start of the spring to now. I mean, like, really the only changes were day one, Takias Crawford was the starting right tackle. Day two, it was Keyshawn Blackstock, and it was every practice after that. Wide receiver went healthy. It's been pretty much the same group and definitely the same, you know, five, six guys rotating in. You know, running back has pretty much been JaQuindon and Rashad DeBinion, mostly JaQuindon Jackson, with Braylon Russell mixing in, maybe as the third guy. I mean, and pretty early this was all done. Defense has been the same defensive line. the same two starting linebackers, except for when they would go to their Mint front and, you know, some of the Okie stuff they do. And the secondary has been the same, start to finish. I mean, aside from Danico Slaughter moving into the starting nickel spot the second half of spring. I mean, there has not been much change at all. An injury here and there might mix it up a little bit, but it's been pretty consistent. I think these players have known where they stand for a while.
All right, Trey, I'm going to try to squeeze this in. This from Greg by way of our Life In feedback says, do we have enough NIL dollars to offer Cam to stay one more year? Too late. He's already declared for the NFL draft.
Too late. Yeah, they've got to get – I mean, they need more NIL dollars for football, though. There's no question about that. Basketball seems to be in pretty good shape, but, you know, football – it's an endless bucket. I mean, you're never going to hear any coach says that, you know, thinks they have enough NIL. But, you know, they need more members. You know, they've got, you know, corporate sponsors. They've got big donors doing stuff too. But they need more of the people doing like $50 a month every month. And, again, the goal is for them is to get 5,000. But that's across all sports, not just for football. So –
So, we don't have time. We'll have to. I'll have to hold this one for tomorrow. And this is a great question. If it's
we're
if
not
it's,
on tomorrow, you need to tell
that's
Trey
true.
That.
Yeah. Oh, Trey, no show tomorrow.
No
Arkansas
show
baseball.
Back baseball. Yeah, okay. 4 o'clock. During that game.
All right, buddy. We'll talk with you then on Thursday. That's Trey Biddy of HogSports.com.
The United Cerebral Palsy Putt-Putt Club Crawl is coming April 27th to Little Rock's River Market. To register your four-person team, text UCP-PUB to 41444.
Love off-roading? There's a 2024 Chevy Silverado Trail Boss at Guatney Chevrolet ready for a driver. It's got improved shocks and suspension, plus wheels made for the off-road. You can make it yours for as low as $61,905. Call, click, or come visit Guatney Chevrolet to hear about our available rebates, and we'll make you the boss of the trail. Come see us in Jacksonville or visit GuatneyChevrolet.com. Chevrolet, together, let's drive.
The $79 garage door tune-up extended through April. Is your garage door too loud? Is it whining for attention? Overhead Door Company of Little Rock will make it all better. They'll perform their garage door tune-up and safety inspection for just $79 extended through April. That's just $79 for up to three garage doors and openers. You need this done once a year, so why not now and for just $79? Schedule now at overheaddooroflittlerock.com.
This year, we considered hiring an ad agency to help with our marketing.
They pitched impressive visuals and a script that was inspiring.
And exotic animal mascots to help grab your attention.
In the end, we just decided to tell it to you straight. Shelter Insurance has award-winning customer service at affordable rates.
Plus, our local agents are there to help you understand what coverage you need.
See shelter agent Monica Reiners in North Little Rock, Larissa Calley in Bryant, or Chris Allen in Stuttgart.
Okay, class, so we all know that E equals MC squared, but what about F and G? What are they squared, huh?
This is Advanced English Lit. What happened to Miss Eileen?
Okay, so I'm not a teacher, I'm an Optimum Tech. When it comes to connectivity, we're experts. If millions of communities rely on us for internet and mobile, you can too. Optimum. Where local is big time. Visit Optimum.com today.
It's a good day to be in Arkansas. You know why? The lotto jackpot is now more than $1.5 million. And the best part? The winning ticket can only be sold in Arkansas. Maybe today. Maybe even to you. Can you imagine? There's a jackpot drawing every Wednesday and Saturday night, so your next chance to win is coming up very soon. Try Lotto today for only $2 per play. Call 1-800-522-4700 for Problem Gambling Helpline.
Try Slim Chicken's new Memphis-style barbecue chicken sandwich for a limited time only. Slim's 100% all-natural hand-breaded chicken breast, shaken in tangy barbecue sauce, layered with fresh, crisp pickles, and that house-made creamy coleslaw, all in a toasted brioche bun. The Memphis-style barbecue chicken sandwich at Slim Chickens. for a limited time only. That's tasty.
Now, back to Drive Time Sports, live from the Eat My Catfish studios. Eat fresh, eat local, eat my catfish. Often imitated but never duplicated, this is Drive Time Sports with Randy Rainwater on the Buzz Radio Network.
Welcome back once again to Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer, I'm Randy Rainwater. Do want to remind you that tonight, tomorrow night, last two nights this week, you can enjoy the 2 for $60 at Benihana, because it's just a Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday special. So, call Maria. Get your reservation right now, 374-8081, 501-374-8081, and you will begin to enjoy the filet, the chicken breast, the colossal shrimp, plus two dinner salads, and two fried rice with chicken. And trust me, there's so much they have to offer on this 2 for $60. You'll probably end up taking a lot of it home with you, and you'll get to enjoy it at least one more time. I think Carrie ate the fried rice with chicken. I think she ate that for about a week, it seemed like. But that's the beauty. You get more than enough. In fact, this probably could feed comfortably a family of four. But don't hold me to that. But I'm just saying, most times or not, there's plenty, 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 a lot of food to go around. So dinner for two for $60. That's the Wyndham Hotel in North Little Rock, Benihana. Call for your reservation now, 501-374-8081. 501-374-8081. Make your reservation now. That way you don't have to wait. Hopefully it wouldn't rain on you, but I've seen it before where there's a lot of folks standing out there waiting to get in. That's how popular Benihana is in North Little Rock in the Wyndham Hotel. Dinner for two for $60, and it goes a long, long way. All right, we are now joined by Kevin McPherson, better known as Hoop Scoop, courtesy of Hogville.net. Well, Kevin, one of the 13 spots we know is now filled for the University of Arkansas basketball roster under John Calipari. You want to make a prediction who might be next?
Boy, I could make a prediction. You know, I kind of thought maybe Carter Knox, the five-star that plays at Overtime Elite in Atlanta. Brother Kevin Knox played for Calipari at Kentucky, was a lottery pick in the NBA a few years ago. He didn't have to get out of a letter of intent. He was committed. Really, he committed to Kentucky back in March, so decommitted just before Calipari was announced at Arkansas, a couple of days before, I believe. So I think he knew that move was coming. And, you know, so maybe the safest guess in terms of the easiest path is a guy who doesn't have to wait on formally getting out of a letter of intent. Because he'd only been committed, but who knows? I mean, that would be one guess. There'll be several other players, you know, six-player class. I think at least five of the six have now either decommitted or asked for release of letter of intent. Billy Richmond, the 6'6 wing from Memphis, today he decommitted and reopened his recruiting. And so he's another one that, you know, would have it easy to just, but, you know, and then – are these players going to want to come to campus, come to Fayetteville and visit? Today, Calipari was in Atlanta at the Overtime Elite Spring Combine. And again, that's where Carter Knox and the other big man that recently got his release from a letter of intent, Somptuous Cyril, 6'10 center, who's also expressing a desire to take visits. You had two more McDonald's All-Americans other than Carter Knox, Jaden Quaintance and Boogie Flan. They both requested releases from their signed letters of intent. And so you just got and then with the portal, we know Big Z was a transfer out of Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
And there's some more names in there. DJ Wagner yesterday went in the portal. He's thought to be a guy that might follow Cal to Arkansas. And then you've got Adu Thiro, a 6'8 wing, who's been in the portal a few weeks, probably going to test the draft waters as well. So there's a lot of a combination of signees he had there, committed players out of high school, signed players out of high school, and then guys going into the portal. And then again, Ivicic was the first one, as you mentioned, the first one to commit to Cal in the portal after half of a freshman season anyway, 15 games at Kentucky last year.
He'll probably have a team next year, don't you think? Whether they come this week, next week, or whenever they come, I'm guessing he'll have enough guys to play. What do you think?
Oh, sure. Yeah, I mean, they're working in the portal. It's not a frenzy like you saw with Musselman, where if a guy put his name in the portal and could fog a mirror, you know, prove that he had a pulse, he was going to get contacted and yeah. get all these names. I think it's a little different process with Calipari, and I think they just kind of zero in on guys, and sometimes those names surface. One of them today, a shooter, a 6'6 wing out of Dayton, nearly 50 shot just over 200 threes this past year, 50% three-point shooter.
Wow. 49.8%,
so let's just call it 50.
Go get him.
But 100, he made 100 threes out of 201 attempts.
Wow.
He's an 88% free throw shooter.
Oh, my gosh.
So that's another portal player.
All right, Kevin, we had this by way of our live-in feedback. Dark Horse says, heard Joe Johnson could be joining Cal's staff. Then I'm looking at this post. Was this at 4:44 today? Says, source tells me Razorback royalty and future Naismith Hall of Famer Joe Johnson could be in play for a staff position at Arkansas under new head coach John Calipari. Another source said he's heavily involved with Coach Cal and his crew. Has really good relationships there.
Sounds like my tweet, Randy.
I'm looking at your picture right now.
I put that out early this morning.
Okay. This is 4:44 screenshot I'm looking at.
Huh.
Okay.
Yeah, I put that out early this morning, so that. That, I don't know where the 4:44 is coming from, but I started my day with that tweet, put it that way, and it was early in the morning. So, I've been having some conversations with some folks, and it might be moving in that direction. Look, Joe Johnson is a difficult guy to pin down. He still likes to do, you know, kind of march to the beat of his own drum. He's continues to play. Now, he's not in the NBA anymore, but he played in the Big Three event every summer. When Team USA calls him for some event, they want him to help. He plays. So he's going to have to – I mean, if you were going to get on a staff like that, that's a game changer in terms of what, you know, hanging it up for good. Now, he's 40-plus, so maybe it's time. But there's serious conversations about that. It may very well happen, Randy. It may be getting close.
Would this be an actual coaching slot?
That's a good question. That much I don't know. I think there are multiple things they're talking about, though, and I wouldn't be surprised if there was some discussion. The thing about the assistant setups now, you can have up to five assistants who have on-court, can coach on-court. Only three can travel to recruit, though. And so, I could see maybe Joe in some kind of hybrid role where he's an on-campus recruiter, helps with players. This is a future Naismith Hall of Famer. I think he'll end up in that Naismith Hall of Fame. And, he'd be a great resource for Calipari on the staff in some form or fashion. But we'll see. We'll see. Joe's kind of a quiet guy and a guy that kind of does his own thing. So this would be so I think he'd be up for the task. There's no question about that. But does he want to do it? You know, he doesn't need money. So it's just going to be a matter of where, you know, is this something that he sees as something he can be passionate about and be a part of a really big brand here now in Arkansas under, you know, obviously led by Coach Cal.
We're also hearing, or not hearing, we're being asked about Ronnie Brewer Jr. What are you hearing there, Kev?
Yeah, I think he's still, you know, they're still figuring that out and working through that. So we'll see. I think he may have another option or two out there as well. I think he's going to consider things. I think his preference would be to remain. So let's see what kind of a situation may be in play for him. I don't think anything's been resolved fully on that either. But I do think he's someone who very well may end up with a role on the staff, but we'll see.
How difficult is it right now for Calipari? You said he's out watching players, which he needs to do. He needs to recruit and put together a staff at the same time. Which comes first, or is he on his cell phone while he's watching players trying to do it all at the same time?
That's exactly right. When these guys get busy, and you have to think he's busy with an empty roster. Well, I guess there's one out of 13, so the glass isn't half full or half empty, but it's got something in it. But he's got a lot of work to do, and getting the staff together is part of that. So he's going to have to multitask, and I'm sure as long as he's been around and as excellent as he's been at every stop in so many different facets, and he's a guy, you know, we saw Musselman was kind of a control freak about things, certain things, and I think Calipari does things his own way and everybody falls in line. So I think he's probably on top of things, even though from our vantage point, still a lot of question marks. I think he's closing in on what he's going to do, what he's going to have in terms of a staff, and in terms of he probably has an idea, because I was told as many as 8 players he would feel good about moving into this week. But now it's a matter of when do they actually formally commit and make announcements. We've seen one. You know, I've got my eyes peeled tonight. Yesterday's commitment came just after 5 p.m., just right after close of business, as they say.
Yeah.
So we'll see if there's anybody coming off the board this evening.
Now, I think you reported last Friday. I think that's correct. Speaking of the staff, it sounds like it appears that 4 spots – have been secured, so to speak, and that does not include his son, Brad, who is on Jerry Stackhouse staff over at Vanderbilt. Is Brad expected to be part of this new staff? And Rick raised this question the other day, or just minutes ago, it seemed like. But that is, when can you expect an announcement concerning these additions to the staff?
Yeah, you know, I'm not sure, Randy. I was thinking maybe sometime this week we'd hear something, but who knows? Some of these names you mentioned, Brad Calipari, he'll be, you know, I'm told it may be like a player development kind of role, but I think things can change. Indicators are that his 3 top assistants are coming with him. But Kenny Payne may be in play, and that could change some things for folks, because he'll be a recruiter, the number one recruiter, as he's been in the past.
All right, Kev, hang tight. We got to step away for a moment. That is Kevin McPherson, bearing on his Hoop Scoop, courtesy of Hogville.net. Drive Time Sports will continue.
Watch all your favorite Buzz shows, streaming live on our YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter pages. 103.7 The Buzz, your multimedia fun and game station.
There are no ordinary days in Arkansas. Hike to inspiring summits, bike on world-class trails, or fish in sparkling waters. Or see some of the world's top art collections and explore historic sites dedicated to everything from civil rights to rock and roll. After that, eat some award-winning barbecue and sip a local craft beer. So go on, get out there, and explore what the natural state has to offer. Find out more at Arkansas.com.
Roger Scott for Gravely Moores, working hard once again, making sure my lawn is lush, weed-free, and beautiful. By working hard, I mean, of course, I'm watching Bradley Owens mow it for me. Bradley, tell the good folks hello.
Well, hello.
That's enough right there, my good man. Pay attention, you missed a spot. What he didn't tell you is that you can take your very own Gravely Moore home today at 0% interest over 48 months. That's right, 0% interest on both residential and commercial mowers. Now, Bradley, tell them where you can go get your very own Gravely Moore.
Well, you can.
I'll finish it for you at Chapel Hardware in Pine Bluff or Hoco Turf in Roland.
This is the Pigskin Preacher bringing you the word. The legendary black evangelist Marshall Keeble said, "When a man is ready to obey the gospel, all the devils in hell can't hold him back." I thought of this when I recently had the privilege of baptizing my friend Everett, who has a tracheostomy, meaning that he breathes through a tube into his windpipe. Did I mention that he was baptized by immersion? Watching his determination that day was truly inspiring. Everett's example reminds us that life is fleeting and that we need to do good while we have the opportunity. Double B's ask you for the opportunity to earn your trust by providing friendly, fast, competent service for your busy life. Come by and stock up on the things that you need. Double B's. It's where you gas it, grab it, and go. That's Double B's.
When you get on a bike, you got to watch out for gravel, potholes, and knucklehead drivers.
But after a crash, here's what you got to watch out for. Insurance adjusters. They can be tough on injured bikers.
They might try to pin the blame on you or pay you less than you deserve.
So if you've been injured, here's what you should do.
Call the lawyers who look out for bikers. That's Rainwater, Holt, and Sexton. Motorcycle crash? Call Rainwater, Holt, and Sexton. Anywhere in the state, dial 888-8888. Non-lawyers, spokesperson.
Responsible attorneys, Michael Rainwater and Bob Sexton.
It's Justin Akers from my good friends at Serta Pro Painters. And right here in Central Arkansas, you can get exactly what you need from a painting standpoint, and you can get it from the folks you trust and believe in. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated. And it comes with free estimates. You get great communication along the way and professional painting. There are certain things you should attempt on your own. In my opinion, painting is not one of them. Turn it over to the right folks at the right price. It's Serta Pro Painters. Online at Serta. CertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose CertaPro Painters.
Welcome back to Drive Time Sports, live from the Eat My Catfish studios, where it's much like any of the seven Eat My Catfish locations, minus the always fresh, delicious food options like the family pack catfish dinners. Drive Time Sports, tapped with refreshing sports opinion on the Buzz Radio Network.
Who doesn't want to be the boss? Now, if you need a little more boss energy in your life, you can make it happen with the 2024 Chevy Silverado Trail Boss from Guatney Chevrolet in Jacksonville. They've got it priced for as little as $62,000. Guatney Chevrolet has tons of applicable rebates to help you get a fantastic price. So anyone can be the boss. Now you can pay them a visit at 1301 TP White Drive in Jacksonville. Always say that's the Gregory Street exit right off of 16767, right in the heart of downtown Jacksonville. And be sure and look for that huge American flag. Can't miss it. Or go to GuatneyChevrolet.com. Got to believe you're going to love what you find there online at Guatney Chevrolet. So check it out. They've got a tremendous selection that you can choose from there at Guatney. Once again, joined by Kevin McPherson, better known as Hoop Scoop, courtesy of Hogville.net. Kevin, I'll read you this one from our live feed and feedback coming in from Adam. He said, what about members of Eric Musselman's staff? How many of those guys are still at Arkansas, and how many of them are going to USC with Muss? Now, we did know that Coach Keith Smart, he applied for the Fresno State job, didn't get it. Don't know if he'll be part of that staff at USC with Coach Musselman.
Yeah, I mean, I've really, you know, I reported at the time that, obviously Musselman's two sons who were on the staff, one is an assistant coach, would be going with him, as would Anthony Ruta, who'd been with him at Nevada prior. And then Todd Lee, who was a special assistant to Musselman after coming over, had been a head coach in the Summit League. Which Dakota was it? Was it South Dakota?
I think it was South Dakota, yeah.
South Dakota. And then Caleb Klein, who also came from that way, would also be going with him. Now, outside of that, any other extended staff members, I haven't kept up with it. I believe those names were ones that were to follow him to USC. So I really haven't been paying attention to what he's doing over there. As far as Musselman, I did see he had a photo op with Matt Leinart, and that made its rounds on Twitter. The former Heisman Trophy winner,
mm-hmm.
back when
yeah.
I think USC had won a couple of titles there. I think one year they split a national title with LSU, if I'm not mistaken, when he was quarterback there.
They won one outright, and then Texas beat him in the championship game when he was a senior. Yeah, so they split.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So, but either way, I really am not sure beyond those names that I had reported a while back, and things can change. So I'm not sure what else Musselman's done for, and what they've announced on his staff. So, Keith Smart. Yeah, I mean, I don't expect him to be in the mix in Arkansas. But as far as USC, I'd be surprised. I'd be surprised if he and Musselman are back together. But you never know how that might play out. And I do think, I think we're gonna learn a lot more as the days go by. Today may be a quiet day in terms of commitments. I don't think at this part of the day they'll announce anything with the staff at Arkansas, but you never know.
All right, Kevin, this from Jeff in Monticello by way of our Buzz text line. Jeff says, what are the odds Battle could end up coming back? I think that's a player we'd all like to keep if possible.
Yeah, I don't know if I could put odds on it. I probably lean toward not. But let's see what Calipari's able to do in the portal. I mean, I believe he's going to get several of these freshmen or would-be freshmen that sign in coming out of high school. And then you've got Big Z, the 7'2 Croatian, who's he played 15 games. I mean, it's a very young player. So Calipari's not afraid to put young guys on the court. We know that. But I do think he's going to get in the portal and try to pull some veteran players. And I'm not sure yet will he be able to pull guys in that might not leave room for Battle. And I'm not sure that he has designs on retaining Battle, but you never know. When you've got 13 to fill, that's a big number. Now you're down to 12, but so you just never know if he's going to turn to any of the players that are remaining in the portal. The other two would be Devo Davis and Layden Blocker, in addition to maybe Caleb Battle. But at this point, I don't have any reason to think that it's likely, and I'd probably lean toward less likely that he'd be coming back in terms of Battle.
All right, Kevin, you may not have an explanation for this. We are confused on one hand because there is the SEC transfer rule that says you cannot do an interconference transfer in the spring for football. Why is that then allowed in basketball? You may not know the answer to that, but Cameron says the SEC transfer rule was probably put in order by coaches due to the many teams completing installs during spring practice. They do not want any of that information leaking to conference opponents, which, has a little bit of validity, but I don't think that would stand up in court, on the other hand. But why is it that football doesn't allow interconference transfers for football, but then why basketball? Why do they allow the interconference moves?
That's a great question, Randy. I like the answer or what you've read there. I think with a lot of things with NCAA, like you said, it wouldn't hold up in court. Some of these NCAA rules are challenged in court. They, they get overturned or they get overridden or they the court weighs in with something that's contrary to what the NCAA would like to have. So who knows? That's a good reason as any, I guess, what we heard. But I've not tried to drill down on that and learn the answer to that. So I don't know.
No.
So when I was hearing Trey read that, Randy, does it apply in the summer too? So in other words, if once the spring semester is over, can they transfer? Is this?
Well, I would think. Yeah, that's a great point, Rick. I would think once school has run its course, then they would be free then to transfer to an SEC. I mean,
I would think so.
I would think so. Yeah. Yeah. Like, I guess you just have to wait a while.
Yeah.
This from Jimmy and Roland. He says LSU should look at hiring Keith Smart as an assistant. Okay. I don't know that Keith is looking around. Okay.
Maybe looking for a job.
Maybe he is. This one surprised me, Kevin, talking about not only going into the transfer portal, but Arkansas, according to other sources, have said that Arkansas's contacted Tennessee transfer forward Jonas Adu. Have you heard anything about that?
Yeah, in fact, Arkansas may be one of a handful of teams here that might be still in it for him. And this was second team All-SEC and had multiple double-doubles on the season, including that big 29-point win in Fayetteville where it seemed like he could do no wrong. 23 points, 12 rebounds. He was 11 of 14 from the field. I was there that night, and nobody in Arkansas's front line could match him. I mean, he was just had his way. And he did, you know, he had some really good games this year. And, again, he's a guy that really developed over time. He's got another season to go. But, you know, you wonder why a guy that had that kind of success at Tennessee is looking to move on. But NIL maybe. I mean, but Arkansas could be in play here. One to keep an eye on, Randy.
Yeah, I liked him. I thought he was a good player. You're right. Orlando Antigua. Chin, yep. Ronald, Coleman, yep. Chuck Martin, yep. And James Bruiser Flint. That is the four that is expected to join Arkansas and the staff of Coach John Calipari. All right, Kevin.
And Brad Calipari. Thanks, guys.
All right, buddy. That is Kevin McPherson, better known as Hoop Scoop, courtesy of Hogville.net. A reminder, we've got one more segment. And then at the bottom of the hour, it's Arkansas and Texas Tech. Game will be on ESPN2, but you'll listen to it right here on the flagship station, 103.7 The Buzz.
Visit Arkansas's premier Forest River dealer, specializing in the sales and service of the Forest River lineup, along with a large selection of quality pre-owned RVs. We have an RV for every lifestyle and a payment for every budget. Plus, as part of the Camping World Dealer Network, you will have access to our national network of lenders, nationwide service network, and all of the Good Sam products and services. We can't wait to serve you at our newest location in Little Rock. Details and disclaimers.
Love off-roading? There's a 2024 Chevy Silverado Trail Boss at Guatney Chevrolet ready for a driver. It's got improved shocks and suspension, plus wheels made for the off-road. You can make it yours for as low as $61,905. Call, click, or come visit Guatney Chevrolet to hear about our available rebates, and we'll make you the boss of the trail. Come see us in Jacksonville or visit GuatneyChevrolet.com. Chevrolet, together, let's drive.
Fence Brokers presents Razorback Graffiti every Monday morning. Call Morning Mayhem and let them know how you feel about how they did. One sentence and one sentence only.
A lot of talk.
Why do you have to talk like that?
And a lot more attitude.
You have a problem? Turn off your station.
103.7 The Buzz. KABZ Little Rock.
Buzz News with KARK's Claire Kreitz.
report from the Arkansas Legislative Audit over the governor's $19,000 lectern has finally been released. The report shows the governor's office was potentially non-compliant with state laws in seven areas. That includes paying for the lectern before it was delivered, capitalizing it as an operating expense, and improper record keeping. The governor's office called the audit deeply flawed. The 6th Judicial District prosecuting attorney and the attorney general are reviewing the report. Methodist Family Health is celebrating 125 years. The organization has created new home and hope for all throughout difficult times during war and the Great Depression. Over the years, the facility has expanded to provide not only short-term care, but also treatment and therapy options for the whole family. This is Claire Kreitz for the Buzz Radio Network.
Are you still on the sidelines? Then it's time you suit up and get in the game. Download Arkansas's favorite sports wagering app, Bet Saracen, today.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center
with KARK's Juliana Cullen.
Clouds linger throughout the rest of the afternoon with a breezy southwest wind and warm temperatures near 80 degrees. This afternoon into this evening also brings us a chance for scattered showers and a few thunderstorms. A few thunderstorms could also be on the strong to severe side with some rain lingering into the overnight hours. This is meteorologist Juliana Cullen with the Arkansas Storm Team for the Buzz Radio Network.
Buy one, get one free at the Riverfront Steakhouse. This Thursday night, we're going to have prime rib, 12 ounces of prime rib served with all the mashed potatoes you can eat. Buy one, get one free.
Hey! Saturday! Oh my gosh, John Denny was great. Great to have Justin Moore back. Rick Schaefer was all over.
Peyton Stovall
was outstanding. Tomorrow will be at Luxury Pool and Spa. Their big annual sale, 20% off everything in the store in Conway. Plus, Craig O'Neill.
Hannah Gamble.
Boom, that's all you need. Morning Mayhem.
Each spring pollinates the inventory at Guadney Buick GMC. And right now, the lot is blooming with huge savings during the first annual Pollenpalooza sale. Right now, you can get into a new Encore GX with just $299 a month or a brand new GMC Terrain for $359 a month, both with zero down. I'm telling you, these deals are nothing to sneeze at. So pop a Claritin and browse their inventory in person next to Sam's Club in North Little Rock or shop online from the comfort of your home at GuadneyBuickGMC.com. It's the first annual Pollenpalooza sale at Guadney Buick GMC because nobody is allergic to a good deal. Guadney Buick GMC is offering 2.9% for 72 months on GMC Sierra equipped with 2.7 or 5.3 engine. 2024 Buick Encore GX as low as $299 a month with zero down and zero first month payment. GMC Terrain at just $359 per month with zero down and zero first month payment. Buick Envision at 1.9% for 60 months. All offers with approved credit. Guadney Buick GMC next to Sam's Club in North Little Rock. GMC, we are professional grade.
This is Pat Bradley for Whit Davis. Do you feel a draft around your windows? Does condensation constantly build up? What about high energy bills? It may be time for you to reach out to my good friends over at Whit Davis. Not only do they sell replacement windows, but they can also refer to you to a host of professionals who'll measure and install them for you. New windows can improve your home's energy efficiency while boosting your curb appeal. So what are you waiting for? Give Whit Davis a call. And remember, Whit Davis Lumber Plus is more than just a lumber yard.
Hey, it's David Basil, and the annual Luxury Pool and Spa 20% off store-wide sale is going on now through this Saturday. Don't miss it. This sale includes everything store-wide, including patio furniture by Fisco, rebates on Pool Life and Bakwasil pool chemicals, and even spas like the one I have at my house are discounted lower than truckload pricing. Daily giveaways include PK Grills and Luxury Pool and Spa $150 gift cards. It's a 20% off store-wide sale going on now through Saturday at Luxury Pool and Spa in Conway and Russellville. Check them out online at luxurypoolarkansas.com.
Hi, it's Frank Fletcher from the Fletcher Dodge store here in Sherwood. Folks, if you're shopping for a new car or truck, I hope you'll come see us and give us a chance to earn your business. We have huge discounts, 0% financing available, and we'll give you $1,000 over Kelley Blue Book value for your trade-in. Folks, I guarantee you a hassle-free buying experience. And if you've had credit problems in the past, listen to this. We have an easy pre-approval process. Just go to FletcherCredit.com to get started. You can be pre-approved in minutes. It's really not hard. FletcherCredit.com. Folks, we're also still buying cars every day. If you got an old car or truck you want to turn into cash, bring it to Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood and ask for Chris or Andy. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Shop in person or shop online at FletcherDeals.com. Thank you.
Are you ready for a better forklift experience? River Valley Tractor and Castle Forklift have teamed up to manage your material handling needs. From diesel, lithium, propane, and so much more, Castle's product line is versatile, ready for the next generation of consumers to make every job easier. Step into the future of forklift innovation. Choose Castle. Visit River Valley Tractor, your authorized Castle forklift dealers in Central Arkansas.
It's Pat Bradley for Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, where their customers are always number one. Speaking about numbers, 6% APY is still available at Alcoa. Earn up to 6% interest on your checking account balances for doing the things you already do, like using your debit card and direct deposit. You can also get your ATM fees waived. Apply today for your free Kasasa checking account and earn up to 6% APY at AlcoaCommunityFCU.org. Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, serving Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry counties.
Live from the Eat My Catfish studios, it's time for Arkansas's number one caller-driven sports show. It's Drive Time Sports on the Buzz Radio Network with your hosts, Randy Rainwater and Rick Schaefer. Lock it in and get ready to dial us up. Drive Time Sports is on the air.
Hour number three of Drive Time Sports here on the Buzz Radio Network. Rick Schaefer standing by in Northwest Arkansas. I'm Randy Rainwater from the Capital City. Once again, this program note, at the bottom of the hour, we will join Arkansas Razorback Baseball tonight taking on Texas Tech. Pregame coverage starts at 6:30 in our flagship station, 103.7 The Buzz. Then at 7 o'clock with the first pitch, so keep it right here. Also want to remind you how simple, how easy it is to bank with First Security, because you can either bank online or there's mobile banking. Now, it's convenient, it's secure. Now, with the First Security online and mobile banking, that allows you to manage your banking accounts on your own time. You can check your balances, you can view your transactions, you can transfer money between accounts, and you can pay your bills. Yeah, quite simple. To get started online, just go to fsbank.com, click on the enroll link, and then just follow the simple steps. Plus, you've got all those ATMs that you can do convenient banking as well. There's over 90-plus banking ATMs across our state, and many of them you can do just about anything you need right there at that banking center. That's First Security Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender, only in Arkansas. That's First Security Bank.
And you can use your First Security Bank card if you'd like to sign up for the Brandon Burlsworth annual football camp.
Yeah, I saw that.
Randy,
yeah.
The dates are May the 31st and June the 1st. It's only $45. It's for boys and girls ages 7 through 15. There can be a lot of former Razorbacks there, several of Brandon Burlsworth's teammates. I saw a couple of them, Chad Abernathy and Jodine Davenport. I saw them at the Dean Weber Memorial. I'm sure there were others there as well. But at any rate, they will have it on May 31st and June 1st. May 31st in Harrison, and June 1st in Little Rock. The $45, you need to register in advance at brandonburlsworth.org, and you need to register by Friday, May the 24th. So there you have it, brandonburlsworth.org. That's as easy as it gets. That's for the Burlsworth Foundation Camp, $45, May 31st, June 1st.
Didn't you say the 23rd?
24th is 24th. When you have to pre-register by the 24th. Pre-register by May 24th. The camps themselves are May 31st and June
1st. No. It is the 23rd Brandon Burlsworth camp.
Oh, the number of it. Yes, it's the 23rd.
23rd annual. Okay, I was getting confused there for a moment.
When you think, and I know a lot of our listeners have seen the movie Greater, even if you didn't weren't around when Burlsworth died or you were very young and don't remember much of it, but you think about this. So he died in an automobile accident in 1999. His last year at Arkansas was 1998. So we're now 25 years from that, and you think about the impact that the foundation has had. Now, I'm not about to say that Brandon wouldn't have started a foundation if he'd have been an NFL player, which he was scheduled to be a starter as a rookie. They handed him the playbook. He was, you know, they were really impressed with him with the Indianapolis Colts. So we don't know if there would have been a foundation from that point, but they have impacted hundreds and hundreds, perhaps thousands of kids in Arkansas with eye care and so many other way things. That who knows
how many kids
have that impact if he'd have been alive.
How many kids do you think have attended?
Oh, these
maybe
camps?
They're only
3 years.
Yeah, over the years, just how many kids, just one time even, attended a football game at Reynolds Razorback Stadium?
Well, yeah, that's a cool deal too. So the Burlsworth Foundation has that little pie-shaped section in the south. It'd be the southeast corner.
Southeast corner.
Reynolds Razorback Stadium, and they get announced every time after the game. They get a chance to meet the players, the coaches, the spirit squads, entertain them before the games. There's usually a sorority or fraternity on campus, usually a sorority on campus that furnishes a meal for them. It's really a deal, and these are kids that it's their first time to ever go to a Razorback football game.
Right.
And they're from all parts of the state. Having worked at Springdale Public Schools for 15 years, I know that even the Springdale schools, as close as they are, have had a few times when they had students from their schools were able to attend. They come from far away as West Memphis. They don't know the starting times of the game when they pick the groups. And we've seen some that will have to drive 4 and 5 hours for 11 o'clock kickoffs. Mm. But it's a heck of a deal. And so the athletic department's been very good about that. In continuing its relationship with the Burlsworth Foundation, and well should.
Awesome. 23 years
and counting. Years.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. All right, Rick. We spend a lot of time talking about the good old transfer portal.
Do we?
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, I think we do.
Last year, nearly 650 FBS. Scholarship players transferred during the spring window. That includes more than 300 from the Power Five schools. Now, we know this has happened, so no one really knows what to expect out of this latest window that is now open. But it's reasonable to expect that there will be more players available in this year's cycle, since the one-time transfer rule is currently suspended. I don't know why they used to say, forget it, it's over, it's done with. It's not even suspended, it's over. That means, I was reading today, I can't remember the number, but there were several who will be working on, in some cases, on their fourth and fifth schools.
Good grief. That's just, they've made it too easy. You know, they have. They've just made it too easy. And part of it, again, is because, as you pointed out, even on this SEC rule, once they get taken to court, they lose every time.
Sure, absolutely.
The rule was put in that if you transfer, you can transfer once freely, but if you transfer once, the second time you transfer, you're supposed to have to sit out a year. That's gone because somebody sued.
It got challenged, yeah.
Yeah, so now the NCAA, they can't even enforce their own rules. So how are you going to stop this? And we talk about the NIL and thinking, okay, you've got to put a limitation on it. Who's going to do that? You can't do it. You're going to go to these schools that have lots of money and say you can't overpay? I was reading the Democrat Gazette did an interview with the new director of The Edge, and they asked him quite a few questions, and he answered them all. And I thought, it's if you haven't looked at it on Whole Hog Sports, you ought to do that. And one of the questions was, how come there's no transparency on this? And it was a very good answer, because while Arkansas may pay more than some schools, maybe they don't pay as much as others. If someone knew what Arkansas paid a linebacker, for instance, then all they have to do is go to a booster and say, hey, we need this guy, and we need to pay more than they're paying mm-hmm. to get him. And so then it becomes open competition, and people know what's going on. So that's why it's pretty secretive on what each athlete's getting. And anyway, they asked him, you know, how coaches cannot contribute, staff members cannot contribute to the Edge, because that's kind of like buying your own players. You can't do that. They are hoping to get up to 5,000 donors of even as small as $25 a month. If they can, there are different ways to do it. If you put it into a tax deductible fund, which you can, then that money must be used for athletes to do charity work. So let's say they've got, I assume they have some nonprofits that they're working with. And so let's say you're working with a nonprofit, Champions for Kids, my wife does. Okay, I don't think that's one of them, but nonetheless, let's say you were doing a Champions for Kids project, you went into a school, then they could pay you, not Champions for Kids, but the Edge could pay you for that work that you did. Then there's another fund that you can give that just goes directly to them regardless. And that money is basically, the way I understand it, just, hey, it's nice to have you here, here's some money. And then they have businesses that can get involved. And what they'll do is they go to the Edge and they say, we're looking for an athlete that fits our company, and they'll pair you up with somebody. Or they may just say, we want this guy or this girl, and they'll say okay, and they make the arrangement. So that's the way the Edge is working with potential donors. He was also open. They said their goal is 5,000. They were asked, how many you got right now? He said, we're a little bit past 500. That means they got a long way to go.
Wow.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean they don't have any money, because again, I'm sure there's some larger donors that have put enough money in for them to operate, but I think that's why, and I was surprised that they said that, but they did, and that's why Hunter Yurecek made the point several times that the John Calipari hiring need Razorback fans to get involved. He was asked, what about wearing your donors out? You know, they're already contributing to the foundation. They're buying tickets. They're doing all these other things. Do you worry about them, about, you know, people getting tired of giving so much money? Yes, that's definitely a concern. They want to make this as easy as they can on donors. That's why they're accepting, if you get into the Edge, you can contribute as little as $25 a month. Well, and multiply it out, that's $300 a year, which is not a large contribution, but that's why they're, even contributions at that level, they're happy to get, and that would be among the 5,000, simply because numbers do count. You know, that's originally how the Razorback Foundation started, Randy. When Coach Broyles, he went to some of the heavyweight contributors, met them in Little Rock, I think this is in 1973, and basically said, here's what we need. And people like Stevens, and there were many others that were heavy hitters at the time. Obviously, Tyson Walmart and J.B. Hunt were not in that category at that time. And here's what we need to have an athletic budget over and above football. And several contributed that day. Then you started the Razorback Foundation, and it was, hey, of course, you're talking about 1973 or 74, people could give $25, period. I think that's all it cost to join the Razorback Foundation at that time. It's $65 today to get it to become a member, which is comparable. And the whole idea was, a lot of people giving a little would give you enough. And then there would be some heavy hitters, obviously, that would contribute too. So that's kind of what the Edge is doing, is get as many people involved as possible, even at a lower amount.
Hmm. I'll have to read that article. I saw the headline. I just didn't have a chance to read it, but I need to go back and look at it a little bit closer. The other part that makes this unlimited transfer ridiculous in some regards, there are several notable players who will transfer for the second time this offseason. In other words, they transferred in during the winter, and now they'll be on the move again.
Like the Alabama offensive line?
Yeah, like the offensive line with Iowa. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, he's going back to Alabama.
How crazy. How crazy. And you wonder how many of that will be because they were able to renegotiate a larger NIL package elsewhere.
Or maybe they went and found out they weren't going to get what they thought they were.
Yeah, that's a good point, too.
They shouldn't have lost. Or maybe they figured out they were just happier where they used to be, and the money didn't matter. They'll go back.
That would be, I would think, the exception, not the rule.
Probably.
Let's talk with Jeff. Jeff, good afternoon. Welcome to Drive Time Sports.
Hey, good afternoon, guys.
Good afternoon.
Question about the NIL. I know that we are, considered a state college, so they have to announce salaries for all the state employees.
Yes.
And the players are using their name, image, and likeness to get so-called jobs or whatever, doing commercials or whatever for this.
Right.
But if they are using the University of Arkansas logo, name, or whatever, is that not like a conflict or infringement rights or whatever, and they would be considered a state employee?
Originally, that was an issue. The NCAA ruled that that's not an issue because they're using the player's name, image, and likeness, and obviously it's because they're an athlete at that school. So at first, when they did those things, yeah, you couldn't use the school logo, you couldn't use the uniform or anything else. Now you can, but that doesn't make you a state employee, and the money that they're being paid does not come out of state funds. Now, to me, the only solution to this, to make it equitable for everybody, is for money to come out of your athletic funds. When that happens, there's going to be a whole new set of rules, because does that make your athletes employees? I mean, you may have to look at it that way.
Okay, but head coaches, for instance, Calipari, mm-hmm. his salary and stuff is not coming out 100% out of state funds,
no.
And they still announce everything on it.
They do. Mm-hmm. I don't know if that's a disclosure rule or what it is, but you're exactly right, because he'll make more money coming out of the Razorback Foundation than he will from the athletic department dollars. You're right.
Right. Okay. Well, I was just kind of curious about that, how they could use, you know, the U of A's information and stuff and
NCAA said that's okay. And as far as the salaries are concerned, that information comes out of their contracts, which are FOIable. So in their contract, you can see here's what the University of Arkansas is paying them. Here's what they're getting extra, because that's actually in their contract. And that's how you know what the coach's total package is.
Okay. Okay, well, that clears it up a little bit for me. I appreciate the call, guys. Y'all have a great evening.
Thank you, Jeff. This came from LC by way of our bus text line. Rick, what keeps coaches from sending dollars to the NIL under the guise of something else?
They can't. You just can't. Under the guise of what? You know, they're going to have that record if a coach gives to – it's not like you can disguise it. And so, but they can't, because again, the thought process is you're buying your own players, and they don't let you do that. So
supposedly,
that's supposedly. No, I think even the most ardent cheaters in the history of college sports, the head coaches were not paying in the cheating.
Okay, all right. That paper sack over there. that shoebox over there. Don't.
That didn't come from a coach.
Yeah, ignore that.
Yeah, don't. That's right.
I didn't drop it off, by the way. Jared says, if you get 3,500 minimum donors, that's over $1 million. That should be so easy in the state of Arkansas with how great our fan base is.
Well, if they got 50,000, if they got 5,000 giving 50 a month, that's 600, that's $3 million. I think that's what they would like to do. But let's say everybody gets 25, then that's $1.5 million. Surely, and obviously there are going to be some people give 100 a month, and there are people that can afford that. But if you're pulling down 60,000 a year, then you're probably not going to do that. You might give 300, 25 a month, and you're probably going to give it, if you do charitable deductions, you're going to do it that way. If you're using the IRS gives you 24,000 in deduction to start with, so if you don't meet that, then it doesn't matter how you give it. You don't need the tax deduction.
Rick, this is from JW. He says, Rick, can the knuckleball make a comeback? Not knucklehead, but knuckleball.
There is, who was I watching the other night? It was the Phillies. Somebody has a knuckleball pitcher in the major leagues. So can it make a comeback? Nothing ever entirely goes away. There's this pitch now they're calling the sweeper. You think that's a new pitch?
Huh.
No. It's a slider. I don't know if it has the same velocity as a slider, but that's what, and it moves considerably, or a curveball slider. They used to have a combination for that, but that's not a new pitch. It's a new terminology. So can the knuckleball make a comeback? It is very difficult to learn. It is almost impossible to control. That's why you've got these guys that are really good at it, they've been doing it for a long time, and they will tell you, when they release the ball, they're not exactly sure where it's going, but they're good enough that they can get it into the strike zone. But you know, when the target is like low in the outside corner, a knuckleball doesn't always do what you want it to, but it has no rotation on it, and so for the hitter, it's difficult to pick up. And so, but will it make a comeback? I don't know. But there's at least one knuckleball pitcher in the major leagues. I'll have to find out who he is.
Make a dance, baby. Make a dance. All right. Speaking of dancing, coming up next, Arkansas, Texas Tech baseball. Keep it right here for Rick Schaefer. I'm Randy Rainwater. Have a great rest of the night. So long, everybody.
Looking for a great place to work? How about going to doublebees.com and apply online? I mean, it is a great place to work. Each and every morning, start my day off right. I head to Double B's because I want the bean to cup coffee. And what that is, it is a selected roast that I can grind and then produce a hot and fresh cup of my Renoco.